Sorry. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the show. Then I had a serving of pesto. I got some potato chips.
We're old, so we're talking about food.
We did that before. The last show, we were talking about our health scan and shit. I cut that out because that was boring.
So you're sitting up here trying to show me a calorie count.
Before, it was the pre-show. Now we have to be young and hip.
The reason why I second a food scale is you just got to know your healthy food measurements, and then you never need it again.
Right. Like, you told me that.
Yeah, I've told you this before. Like, that's why I can't tell you from a pack of chicken, but if I see it, I'm like, yeah, that's like 4 ounces. That's 6. And I know I'm pretty accurate.
Yeah, because Costco chicken's full of those hormones and shit, so I don't know exactly how much it is.
It's also filled with 20 chicken breasts.
It's to a pack. And I've been eating, if I open one, I eat two chicken breasts a day. Mm-hmm. A whole chicken titty a day. Oh, good. And so. Grilled. I'm cutting down on salt. I have saltless seasoning.
See, that's the hard part.
No, but saltless seasoning is not bad.
It's fucking terrible.
It's the what garlic, Miss Dash, saltless, it's spicy, spicy garlic pan, herb.
But it's still not salt.
No, but then you can put salt on it. I'm not like eliminating salt. I can't eliminate salt. It's not good for anybody. Right. But I was eating like 5 times the amount of daily sodium. It was not a good idea. Okay. So,
well,
yeah, I put salt on my shit, but
2%. Hell yeah, baby.
Yeah, I looked at that casein you recommended for me, and I'm like, oh shit.
You were in worry of salt from Truly's, a sweet drink.
Hey man,
there's no sugars in it though, because it's all artificial sweeteners.
Hey man, 3 grams,
no
three,
protein,
three carbs, bro.
No vitamins whatsoever. It's got a little salt. That's the only thing that's bad about it. Everything else is zero and carb. Percent of 3 grams of carbs.
The essence, it is alcohol. So
yeah, it's like water, alcohol water.
Okay, that doesn't sound great.
The chemicals are going to get us before the lemon chemical, whatever it is. So it's filtered carbonated water, alcohol, whatever that means, natural flavors, and citric acid.
We have zero viewers for a reason right now.
Yeah.
Well, because we didn't tell anybody about it, did you change the name of the title and everything?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Between you two talking about insurance and this shit, I'm about to fall asleep over here.
Well,
I have something to spice it up.
Let's spice up your life.
Yeah, let me please. Tell you that Netflix decided to drop a trailer in Pride Month that, you know, yeah, look, so I wake up, my homie sends me this message, and he's like, bro, just give this a watch. And I was like, okay. And
turn in who's
live and recording. Thank you, VGI.
What
he just said, live and recording.
Live and recording. Good. He doesn't know we're recording.
Turn in Hooch trailer. That's what you're talking about, right?
I know. Now, there's two things. Now, there's two trailers that I've seen over the last 2 days that made me feel very opposite ways. One I wasn't ready for because I wasn't expecting it, and that was because Scooby-Doo and Courage Cowardly Dog have a crossover coming up.
Sure. Sure. That's one thing I noticed with our last episode of you guys' love for cartoons and shit.
Yeah, it was.
I'm like,
a whole show of that.
I'm too old for cartoons. You guys, no, you guys can have it.
I didn't watch
Courage.
If you ever say you're too old for cartoons again, like, you're never, no one's too old. It's that mentality that limits the industry.
I was about to say, like, there was a lot of good writers that it was like, my plot, like, Adventure Time, is too weird and too big to ever be made into a TV show, but I can just draw that shit out. And that's true for Adventure Time, Gravity Falls, Coco, like, almost all of Pixar.
You can make Coco. It's just depressing as fuck.
I don't think you could make Coco.
You can make Coco. I mean, skeletons are spooky. You'd have to do something
Cartoon
with them.
Cartoon Network, you can make Coco.
But
I'm talking about not a cartoon, live action Coco.
Live action Coco.
With that many skeletals and...
With children involved?
Yeah, dead children.
Yeah, they don't do that anymore.
Yeah.
90s, yeah, you could do that. Like now.
But would it look good? You're talking about like 80s janky.
Yeah, of course.
What is Scooby-Doo?
You're talking about Steven Spielberg type shit, you know?
He's not going to do Coco.
But Scooby-Doo...
Well, he shouldn't.
But Scooby-Doo's like Coca-Cola. It's good. But it doesn't change. There's nothing new about it. You're going to enjoy
it. It changes a lot.
I can end this conversation.
Do they?
Right now.
What?
Guillermo del Toro's Coco.
That would be nice.
That would be hella fucking expensive because he would want.
They would give him. He's an Oscar winning director.
With a one monster movie.
Hey, pause. Whoa.
I'm just saying cartoons are whack. Grow up.
I want to see that now. I don't know why I put that in the universe.
Fair enough.
All right, continue.
Well, there's that. But hey, that gets a conversation going. Now on paper, the second trailer should be great. Cartoon, finally including some representation where the primary characters are focused on queer individuals.
Suicide Squad?
No.
Oh, okay. I mean, I'm pretty sure some of them are queer.
But somehow, somehow, I don't even know how this got past the editing room, because... You know what? You know, y'all should just see it.
I don't know what you're talking about, quite frankly, so I'm going completely blind. I don't even know what he's alluding to.
Okay, so I'm curious.
Go ahead and pull it up.
Q4. Oh, Q is, like you said, Marcos, Q is not a letter we should be using right now. I saw, like, Q Yoga, like, just, like, it's just an innocuous name or something. And now it looks super awful.
It's brutal.
Oh.
It is so pandering. I have never seen something like this.
Turn the volume up a little bit. I think I turned it down. We got to hear this.
No, it's as high as it goes.
Okay, I'm in on the computer.
Hey, twink. Oh, hey, girl.
Oh, that's shit.
My job, daddy. Right? We're Q-Force. We're the first queer agents in the field ever.
Non-stop.
That's called an entrance, by the way.
We're the best spies in the world.
Don't hit me hard right now.
All right, freeze. The room's empty. I wasted all that masculinity on nothing.
Not nothing. My little butthole went boop.
Oh my god.
Damn it. You can't pander to the gays. They can smell it. You're acting like Citibank at Pride.
So they made that joke and they...
Yes. I said, I've never just sat at a screen and been like, y'all have the ball.
Jeez.
On Pride Month.
Don't know what to say about that.
Here's the fucked up thing about that. There's something there. The idea, conceptually, I like it.
Mm-hmm. It really was one thing that
But like, there's a good idea in there.
It is.
And somewhere. They fucked it entirely up, man.
Real quick. The ambiguously gay duo. It's that
joke.
Yeah,
it's like that. Yeah. Exactly.
But still. But you can make like a whole like fantabulous group of homosexual spies. That sounds like a great time.
Yeah.
My butthole pucker. I've known enough gay dudes to been around that conversation and stuff to never hear any of them talk specifically about their butthole. It's always kind of alluded to. I don't know why, but that's gross. And I don't mean because it's homosexual. I mean it's because the writing is so gross and awful. It's bad.
I'm with you pretty in terms impressed. Of like the preface.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Premise.
Well, it's the preface. Premise.
Same. Okay, whatever. Same. Sorry.
Shit. Don't ever correct me on that.
Shut up.
He makes more money than you. Go ahead.
That's not a weapon. I didn't
it
say
is.
That.
This is America. That is absolutely
yeah,
a weapon.
Yeah, which is funny because he makes more money and doesn't know words. It's so strange.
His words were correct.
God bless
just
America.
Just think of the money you could make if...
You know what? It's fine. It's whatever. The premise, yeah. Whatever
right.
You want to call it.
The promise,
the
if you
premise,
will.
Is awesome. Like, that's a cool premise. You can get really with it. I actually don't even mind crassness. Crass humor is hilarious.
Yeah.
As long as it's funny.
But it has to be funny.
It has to be funny.
And
it
has to be funny for, like, both parties.
You know
like,
what's funny? The thing is, I hear a lot of comedians and comedy writers complain and shit now because it's so hard, cancel culture, this, that, and the other.
They're a bunch of dummies.
You can't say things anymore.
That's stupid and a lie.
I agree. No, your job... It did get a little bit more difficult, but now it's you just have to be good at your job. It's no more that Carlos Mencia bullshit.
No half measures.
Yeah, no half measures. No falling back on immature jokes and
right.
Stupid shit.
I like.
No, you have to be clever about it.
I felt
it has to be funny.
I felt offended for the LGBTQ community, and I was like,
wasn't expecting that.
Yeah, it's offensive.
Not expecting this. Yeah.
It's offensive, even if it's not like sexually or pridely or what's the word I'm looking for?
No.
I guess whatever. Gay wise, it's like if it were offensive that way. That's what's closest I'm gonna get, baby.
Okay.
But it's offensive because it's terrible and it hurts my feelings that. People can make money writing and have writing careers.
But
that being said, like getting hard in a cat suit, hilarious idea. That's a funny concept. And then they just fucked it all up. Like there's little tidbits.
No, so I will give some positivity here before y'all guys go a little too ham on these writers. They do have every character who isn't straight is also voiced by a character who's who is part of the LGBTQ community.
Okay.
Alongside that...
Wait, I saw David Harbour's name in there.
Yeah, and straight characters are also voiced by straight characters.
Okay.
So they made sure.
Oh, it wasn't just like a token thing.
Yeah, no. Okay. It was and then
Neil Patrick Harris definitely saw the script and went, nah.
He literally must have been like, because you know that this had to have hit his desk. People. This had to have hit his desk.
He already has a relationship with Netflix. Yeah, he was definitely in the loop with this.
But also
got Sean Hayes.
The writers, and I don't know about the producers and directors, but but the majority of the back end team is also gay, homosexual variations
of the
community. So this
went through some channels.
So from what I heard, and from what the Twitter digging I did, it's as if the editor or the editing just chose the worst parts to put together because someone was like, "Hey, look, it's not." No, she.
You know, Netflix has a problem with that, like, because that goes back to Cuties.
Oh yeah, Netflix, and that's not.
And what was the
conceptually
300 and something day 365?
No, that movie itself is just.
It shouldn't.
What movie
exist.
Is it?
No.
What movie is this?
They have two sequels coming out, by the way.
It's 365 days, and yes, I know. I'm watching both of them. I have to.
What do you mean?
After the first one, I was like, this is the worst shit I've ever seen.
He's a completionist.
But I have to watch the other ones. I got to put myself through that.
Okay.
But in terms of this, like the person who was like, hey, I know a lot of the writers there. Like we had a lot of feedback. Like as with any show, it's not gonna be perfect, right? But there's a lot of good within it that they just didn't highlight, and so I'm hoping that with the premise they could really step up. But they got a lot of hate from all parties on this because it was like, yo, it's like I did it in the exact same lens. Imagine a cartoon that was super super, like. And the thing is, we have a cartoon who does it well. The Boondocks. Perfect.
Super, you're gonna say super super black,
yeah,
or super
super,
super
black.
Asian, or yeah, super like, super Mexican.
Super Asian, super super Mexican.
Right.
We're like, shoot, they come out, oh cholo, cholo.
Hey, vato, yeah, how's it going, man? I'm just selling drugs, man. What are you doing? I'm taking a nap, eh? Like, that's like, you know, that's what that's the equivalent of what a Mexican would do. Is that, stop laughing. It's not funny. It's like laughing at that homosexual jokes that they were making. It's not funny.
Because I was laughing at your accent.
Oh, I could. That's because that's not my life. I was never any of those groups or communities. But no, but I thought of it. That's the first thing I thought of when you said that. It's just like, you know, hey, I'm gonna go gay, man. I'm gonna go mess with my pregnant girlfriend. It's like, oh my god, for real? It's the inverse of In the Heights. That's all it would be. Mm-hmm. Instead of going to college, she'd be pregnant. Instead of owning a liquor store,
every stereotype you could think of.
Yeah, he'd be selling weight.
I feel
like
all those stereotypes are Dominican too.
I'm just no. To be fair, yes, but
but
they were not terrible. Like, I don't, the stereotypes are a whole different conversation. We'll get to that later.
Well, they covered Dominicans, not Puerto Ricans. I was about to say they would really have a story to tell about that one.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
true.
Yeah.
Point is, but this is atrocious.
This really is not
bad. Made me feel
all
terrible.
For representation. And
it's
I
not
think
tasteful like
it's
this.
It's not.
That is a very funny scene, though. Yeah, scene from the producers. Keep it gay. Keep it gay. So, in defense of Mel Brooks, everything. Also, we switched heights. Wait, did we switch heights? Nope. No, we switched seats because he stopped getting upset about being punished in the shit chair, so he made me switch.
Hey, I was in this bitch for a while.
No.
Suck it up.
I'm a man.
Speak up. TJ,
I did. That's why I have this chair.
No, he got that chair because he showed up on time. Yours is coming next week.
It's a rotation.
Tommy is
I had
only
it last
child.
Time.
To Tommy is a baby, and he's an old man, and he's going to get hemorrhoids if he doesn't have a soft, cushy chair.
Actually, we should just keep that chair there. Whoever's the last one here, we'll never make a show late on again.
Exactly. But anyway, yeah, that has context. That has context. That's the thing. The whole point is that character...
Mean, our one viewer might not have context for
that. Well, that's because you showed it out of context. But that's not what they advertised the producers on. If they produced it on that scene right there where it's like, yes... and he does it for 10 minutes, then yeah, you have a problem. But you put it in the
it's
context.
It's kind of advertised on worse things, like a play about Hitler.
But but that's the shock value, and it would be bad if it was just like, oh, yeah, we like Hitler. But not only is it we don't like Hitler, we're going to make an embarrassment of him. So everything in that movie is – but the premise of the movie itself, just to defend the producers, is can you make more money with a flop than with a success? That was the whole premise, and so that's the scheme. The way they get there goes through homosexual characters, and it goes through the Nazis, and it, it's exploiting everybody equally, to be fair. So
that's a lot of defense.
It's Mel Brooks.
He really likes Mel Brooks.
I really like Mel Brooks.
But the whole essence of this whole conversation was just to get to don't pander to any group, please. And
they even said it
better.
Themselves.
And just because so you say it doesn't mean you're not doing it, and it doesn't justify that you're doing it. It
doesn't eliminate it, you from that.
Bro, I hope that it comes out dope because I do think that, I do think that it's like to me, if this is what like a Boondocks or like a cartoon or. Or like a cartoon of like where it's unapologetically able to address a group and some of the inner workings of how that works, but still be hilarious and well written.
Right.
That's dope.
But the problem here is the premise of like going back to the producers and using gay characters, hell, even poor manner or a way that's making fun of them is can you make more money off of a flop of a musical than a success? What's the premise of this show? Gay people are spies? What? How crazy is that?
Well, the producer's a movie. I mean, and the Boondocks is like, the Boondocks' premise is literally like, hey, two kids end up in a rich neighborhood, only black ones there.
Right. But that premise alone is stronger than, hey, what if just some gay dudes were just some spies? Like, because you know that with that premise that you have with the Boondocks, there's a lot to go off of. There's a lot of it.
There's a lot to go off of here.
That's not at their expense.
When did this come out?
We're not reviewing it.
No,
he's gonna watch it for his own times.
No, I mean, you.
It's coming out in 2021.
You sit and debate this shit, just watch it and find out.
That's not my first movie.
What? That's your Dave Chappelle laugh. I've never heard that one.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I'm looking up what the writer has written before because I was really curious. With the trailer being as obscene as it is it?
Credentials.
Yeah, no, is it written by a gay writer? Like,
okay. That's a good thing to look up.
Because
yeah.
I was like, well, I don't know if he's gay or not, but his other credits come out. I mean, famously, Brooklyn Nine-Nine is probably his best thing.
I love Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
Solid show.
What else was there? Broad City.
Got another.
These are episodes or these are like seasons or like
these are episodes.
Panel.
Right.
But that's the one that TJ was laughing at.
Pen 15.
It's all good shows.
Yeah. So. Maybe. Who knows?
I've never seen.
It's on Hulu.
You never seen Pen 15?
Never
it's
seen
it. It's a weird, awkward show. But
never seen it because it's on Hulu.
Well, I mean, you get the joke that they're trying to make there.
It's a penis.
Yeah, that's what made it funny.
God, you're 12. People say I'm 12.
Hey, look, I'm allowed
one. If it was vagina, you would be laughing.
No, but you got to make letters out of it. You can't make vagina with letters.
Like boobs with the calculator.
Yeah, if it was boobs with a calculator, I'd be dying.
Next level.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, no, y'all are children.
No, there's no y'all.
And Pen 15 made you cackle like a little boy.
You know, that shit makes me laugh.
Yeah,
so.
Man, tickled my fancy. But also, I don't like Broad City, so he already kind of...
Broad City's coin toss for me.
Yes. I didn't watch the latter seasons, but the first couple were okay.
What's up?
No. I was like, of course this dude was involved in Will and Grace.
Oh, so he's got some gay credentials.
Sean Hayes comes in then.
No, Sean Hayes. Sean Hayes is the one that created the idea. Gabe Lindemann is the one that wrote it.
Okay.
So it's like Sam being like, I have an idea, and then Gabe ran with it.
Man, so he's the idea. So there is an ideas guy in Hollywood. I've always been told there's no ideas guys in Hollywood. Have you heard about those guys? I don't know how to write. I don't know how to produce. I don't know how to work a camera, but I have all these great ideas, man. I just want to, you know.
Michael Bay is a producer, like an executive producer.
It's a whole thing in Always Sunny in Philadelphia where they're trying to write this script and no one actually wants to. How's it going? And no one actually wants to write it. Everybody's like, I'm just an idea man.
Right. Yeah.
Are you going to write this? No.
Right.
I'm an idea man.
Right. That was an idea of mine for a long time because I didn't want to do anything alone. And then I started doing it, and then you guys showed up. And I'm like, yeah, I'm no longer an idea man. This is great. Seriously, it sucks because you just come up with ideas. Like, I'm going to do this, this, and this, and this. And then you don't do any of them. You just look like an asshole. And you look like you're a boring, lazy person.
So I have a thing here.
You have a great idea?
I do. I think everyone here will like it. So, no secret, everybody. Sorry, Sam. We don't get paid for this, right? We do this out of the goodness of our heart, and it's fun because we're all friends.
Hey, this Truly's ain't free, and that chair ain't free, and I switched you. You're welcome.
I'm not drinking a Truly's.
Parking. Parking ain't free.
I have enough Truly's.
You said parking was free.
I pay rent here.
Anywho.
I'll pay your rent and this if I can never, ever have that held against me again.
It's craft services.
I feel like he wins that.
And it wasn't even you.
Yeah, but go on.
Also, I'll take that. Rent. Hey, but anyway, Tommy's making a point.
No, I was just going to say, since he doesn't pay a shit, how about he just does us each like a favor? So not like that. Like
anytime you say a favor.
Because we're so immature.
Come on, man.
No, that wasn't the first thing. And then that was the first thing came to mind. I was like, oh, favor. And then you looked at him, and then you looked back at me. And then when you looked back
at me, there was an evil gleam.
Yeah, I was like, oh.
I heard it. You guys may have not picked it up on the microphones, but it was like a little ding in his eye that said nefarious.
No, completely legit.
Okay, what do you want from me, man?
I always wanted to write a screenplay. I'm okay at it, but I always need.
What, you want like him to write your dialogue?
You want me to write?
No, I'm great at dialogue. I need.
That's the only thing he wants is a strength.
Yeah, I need a co-writer. So you're gonna co-write a script.
Every time I tell you to give me a piece of your media to criticize it, you're like, I don't want. I'm scared.
I'd let you listen to a snippet of anything. You told me go kill yourself.
I did not say that. I just said it needs some just vibes and feel and notes, which is what you do for a friend.
To be fair, that's a terrible note.
Yeah, it's a really horrendous.
Yeah, no, it needs some skibbity bop, man. He showed me an electro tune, and I was like, you know what? It needs some zips, boom, doom.
I want to set the precedent of favors. That should just be natural with friendship.
Yeah, man. I would have done that anyway.
It's a combo of both.
You're like, I need shit.
It's a combo of obligation and friendship.
I'll tell you what. You give me just an outline. Yeah. I'll write a couple of those scenes.
Okay.
I'll write a couple.
I'll voice over them.
These guys are in for free, and I have to do this just to get you to do something. Jeez, man. Friendship. Thank both of you.
No, it's going.
Yeah, guys. Yeah. Friendship, stand and I'm the ace. Hey, friendship, and I'm the dock to that ship. Okay, I keep it all together. I'm the tether the that glue, holds it all. Yeah, exactly.
You would be friends if you weren't around.
Pretty sure we went out like the first time I went out of quarantine. More. I said, I was like, hey, who's
we hung out more when you were gone than when you were here.
That's not true. friends of the show. But if it makes you feel bad, give me money and they'll never see it. Donate now if you think I need new friends.
No, they like us. They'll donate to have you removed from the show.
Actually, yeah, from you know what?
That's his plot. He just revealed his hand. He's like, I'll be his friend.
No, I can't do this.
You can barely show up on time.
That's what I'm saying. I can't answer emails or respond to emails or check emails.
Or messages or
text.
Or smoke messages.
It's not as though, because I'm also the same, but like if you tag me in something, there's like a 75% increase.
When you tell me, just call me, that changed the game.
Just call me. I'll answer, and I'll call you
same
back.
Here. Yeah. I'll be like, oh, shit.
And then you don't answer. You don't answer.
What do you mean, my phone?
Yeah.
If you call?
Yeah.
Have I ever not answered?
Absolutely.
Was it after 11?
No. Yeah. He was just canoodling, and he was just like, nope. He throws his phone across the room when he's canoodling.
Well, yeah. Bro, yeah.
Yeah.
But my thing
is. but that's the thing. He's out here canoodling in these streets when I need shit done. That's why you don't get shit done, because I need it done when I need it done.
He's just talking about Tommy's takeover.
But Tommy's takeover. Oh, being nefarious.
I don't know how you didn't like make that natural connection, because you know that after like 12, You've called me before, but it's like some reason you're like, that's only because he's up at night, but during the daytime it must be easier to text. I'm like, no, just call me. I'm like around.
Well, you're like asleep at three in the three. Like Marco's like, text TJ, see where he's at, like on any given weekend. And it's like, he's asleep right now. I call.
I'll
get a text at 10 p.m. He's like, ah, oh, bro, I just woke up. Probably. It's like, TJ.
No, that's fair.
The Tomsilence will be born.
Yes.
That sounds. I'm gonna start calling you Tom if you don't quit.
People call me Tom.
Do they really? It's gross.
They don't know me.
It's really weird.
I don't like that.
Yeah. That's how I differentiate. I'm gonna call you Tay Tay.
Don't ever do that.
And then
I've actually given up on inviting TJ. He just comes when he wants. He
let him show.
He saw us drinking at Turnstile and was like, "Yeah, fuck that."
Oh,
he
really?
Drove by.
No, oh, no,
he was like,
that's a bad.
These broke ass motherfuckers.
Okay, so straight up, we were coming back from like a reservation type dinner, and I had to take a shit.
Of course, you're not going to Turnstile.
I had to take a shit. I see y'all at Turnstile.
He was in a tux and shit.
No, right?
I was just like,
it was one of those situations where like he would pull up and be like, "Hey guys, hey, come here." And then throw something at you and drive off. Right? Drinking Cristal.
Right. Also, maybe I'm just not classy, or maybe I've been single an awfully long time. All those things are very true. I haven't had reservations in a long time, let alone.
Never had reservations.
Like, it's been years since I've had reservations anywhere.
I've never made them myself.
So the problem is, it makes it sound more bougie than it really needs to be. But it's just because.
Yeah, no.
I was about to say, I had reservations at a Brazilian steakhouse a month ago.
Yeah, yeah, but you're still letting them know. Yeah.
Did you make it yourself?
Yeah.
Oh, good for you. I went to that Brazilian steakhouse, but my boss made the reservations, and it was a company.
So for me.
That's
I was
badass
just like,
company. If you include the Shiner too,
bro. If you tell me an idea, I go through checks and balances and I try and be accommodating.
You also disappeared for like 3 weeks. One of those was your vacation.
Two, actually, were
fair enough.
Yeah,
vacation.
But with
don't
his
do
job,
anything.
Which handles digital media, it made sense. It's like I need a break. I'm throwing my phone into the forest and living among the bees.
Like literally, I'm like the thing is, whenever I disconnect, whenever I took a true vacation, I. Want to stay the fuck away from my cell phone.
Yeah.
I want to stay the fuck away
I'm
from
not one of those people.
No, I want to stay the fuck away from communication because that's all I'm on. I'm always worried.
Well,
I'm always doing presentations, talks.
Life.
I'm looking at outlets all the time. The blue and white one, the red and white one, the Instagrams, the fucking TikToks. That's all I'm doing.
See, I have to stay connected with the world.
Yeah.
Not like communication while just knowing what's happening, so I would check just for that. But as far as talking to people, I understand that. Yeah
The last time I was disconnected from my phone for more than 3 hours, it was tubing when I got fucking drunk.
I'm sure you didn't have any missed calls or messages.
All my friends are here and were with me, all the ones that mattered anyway. He wasn't.
we're digging. I don't know. We were vibing.
Right.
Yeah.
It was like,
that's okay. We going.
Only person that wasn't there was Ray, and Ray's in Columbia right now. Somehow.
Are we going on the Sunday?
Oh
yeah.
Cool.
What?
We're going tubing July 4th.
Right. Which is not this weekend, but next.
Yeah, I gotta drive up to Dallas during the week next week. Because I was like, oh, Mom, I'm going to come see you July 4th weekend. And then I was like, fuck, I want to go tubing. So I'm going to go see you July 4th.
Yeah.
Days before.
And then I side mentioned that our friend Ray is in Columbia right now for some fucking reason.
I saw his Instagram.
Yeah, one of his homegirls is Columbia. And she's like, I guess, big birthday party. And then he's in Columbia now. I don't know how he's able to.
His shit
I thought
like
it's crazy country. Right there right now.
Yeah.
No, that's Brazil.
No, yeah.
Well, that's all the same. It's all bad.
South America.
Point
but
is,
Brazil is specifically bad with the variants.
Oh, yeah. But yeah, he's in Colombia right now. I was like, wait a minute. What? I thought he didn't. I thought COVID took his job. Apparently that Stubbs money is real good for his one show he's done so far. Or whatever show he did.
He did the DMX.
The DMX
thing.
One. Whatever.
Well, that's why, yeah.
He did one DMX honorary show, and now he's in Colombia. I should be a rapper. Good.
Well, he's actually.
Saying.
He needs a break.
Not to put his stuff out there, but he's making a lot of money. Doing the side Fiverr gig.
Writing and stuff like that. Yeah. He told me to write a fake review for him, so I did. Because that's what friends are for.
Like, glad you do something for someone.
We're going to vote you out of this show.
I looked at him. You guys are fine. He ran the show. He ran the show while he was... I mean, this is his show.
He runs this operation.
He runs the HR of
if
this operation.
If he leaves, I leave.
Okay. I'd rather you just leave.
Oh, after this show.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, I don't feel like getting up.
Well, you have the nice chair. It should be fucking easier. It's
great compared to that.
God damn it. I have one shitty chair if you guys don't get it.
It'll fuck
you is
up.
That there's a luxury chair, which is the one I sit in and the Marco's in right now. Two equally chairs I stole from the old Double Toasted Studio, and then just a fold-out chair. And the fold-out chair is for whoever gets here last. And just because it's been Tommy the last four times doesn't make me a bad villain, okay?
Has it been him the last?
It's been him at least twice, probably three. If you on the show that he wasn't on,
I straight up, after my stint, I said fuck that. That's in rotation. I'm good.
Yeah,
I thought we were doing the rotation thing.
No,
it did become the punishment chair.
It did become the punishment. Well, now a new chair's on the way. Prime Day got to me. I bought a weighted blanket.
When does this come in?
Next Friday. Who gives
Why
a shit?
Why did you buy a weighted blanket?
What?
Because it was like 80% off, and I wanted to try it.
They're not that
the summer just started.
Yeah, right.
I know.
The worst time to get away.
I know, but it
you
just
don't crank your AC up.
I bet he bought flannels too. Just
no. Well,
he always buys flannels.
No, I bought those flannels because they were like $3 a piece, and they're good. They were on clearance.
So you did buy flannels?
Flannel what?
Like months ago? Sure, these.
Well, obviously, then I was hoping something else.
Yes, flannel underwear. What are you talking about?
I was hoping.
I bought a squatty potty. Because I wanted to try
it. You have the audacity to talk about me.
What?
You son of a bitch.
What? That's good for bowel movies.
I always wear my hoodie shirt things.
Oh, yeah, but I wore a t-shirt when it was 98 degrees. I'm inside on a show, have to look good. I have to keep this. You've literally been wearing that four times in the row the last times
no,
I've seen you.
They're different. They're literally different
Doug,
colors.
Funny. They're really not.
Different shades of
Wasn't
gray.
He wearing that on Saturday?
Why do you have to be so mean?
Ask him. He's he's trying to get this out of me.
So now I have to go home and take a picture of all of these just to prove.
Yes, please. It. Like JJ's 13 backpacks. I want to see the picture of all of your hoodie long sleeves. Your and you guys give me shit for wearing long sleeves.
But they're thin. And
they are thin.
Why do you say guys? I've never given you shit.
You haven't, to be fair. But Marcos definitely has.
Neither have you with me.
Yeah.
You never defended me, so it counts against me. If you're not with me, then you're my enemy.
I'm not a Captain Sabaho, bro. I'm a bystander. I'm that nigga who, like, if you get in a fist fight, I'm gonna ask questions. I need to know what the context
you,
of
which is why you are in your life where you are.
Yeah, I was like, right? Bro, people be, what is it?
Motherfuckers are reckless.
I legitimately, I was out with a group of people. They were about to squab up.
Yeah.
I was like, Taylor, you're the biggest dude here. That's the expectation, right? That I'm supposed to just jump up because I'm bigger
Quick
than
question,
most.
Gotta put it out there. Were you the only black person in this
No.
group? Oh, okay.
See, I wasn't.
All right.
And the thing is, they're like, yeah, we gotta back up our boy. No questions. I said, nah, nigga, I got questions.
On site, TJ.
No.
On site. For all you guys, on site. If you guys are in some shit, I'm punching somebody in the closest vicinity.
You want to hear a great example of why, that's not a good idea?
Because if you're getting jumped, guy punching you, dude.
That's okay. No, that's like past the point. And that's the point of like, yeah, there's no questions I can ask. But if things are getting heated, and it's like, yeah, I'm gonna be the first thing to come up. Hey, what happened? Hey, what's here?
Yeah.
So, cautionary tale real quick. Guy from LaGrange, great guy. His name was Kyle. Had a scholarship to go to A&M for business, was a manager at HEB at the age of 20.
Okay.
While he went to school for management, doing great. Also had a bit of a drug problem. Adderall and shit, of course, started out for college.
Okay.
Weed, of course, fine, whatever, I suppose.
I'm just hearing normal.
Yeah, sounds like a cool dude.
Yeah, I mean,
say less.
Not a drug problem.
But he loved it with a passion. It was his hobby and all that good stuff. So he decided, well, I love this so much, let me just go to Colorado every weekend and stock the fuck up. And
who can afford that?
Well, he was making great money. He was a
manager. Oh, he was manager.
Yeah. Manager at HEB with probably
with
no
his
other
parents.
No other obligations.
With a scholarship, so he was
wasn't
paying for great. And he already had money, came from a good family. It's LaGrange. He lived in a nice neighborhood.
Right.
Very down to earth guy though.
Right.
Nice. So yeah, love that. Went to Colorado, you stocked up, did that, was like, hey, I can make money, a little bit of change on the side. So start selling a little bit to friends and such, he said. Continue to do the Adderall because it's very tough going to Colorado back and forth, yada yada, so on and so forth. So he's high on Adderall, trunk full of drugs, some to sell, some for personal. Gets busted, gets locked up, scholarship gone. Had to go through all the process, all that good stuff.
Okay.
But, you know, got, you know, just a little bit of time, got off. But scholarship was gone, got fired from HEB. I was guilty pleasure connection. I was went to Jack in the Box maybe 7 months ago.
Cops are waiting outside of Jack in the Box on any given day.
All the time. I mean, it's more depressing than that, Mark.
Oh.
I hadn't seen this guy in years. My Jack in the Box on McNeil. Guess who's at the window? Hey, Tommy, what's up, man? I look in. I'm like, what? He's like, what's up, dude? What's happening? It's Kyle. Not a manager at Jack in the Box, just working the window. A week after that, apparently he got fired from Jack in the Box. He OD'd on pills.
In the Jack in the Box?
I don't know if it was in the Jack.
Oh, okay. This is after.
He posted his recovery on Facebook.
Okay.
And that was the last I've heard of him.
So time out. How did that come?
I was like, what?
I completely forgot the point now.
Like I said, cautionary tale has nothing to do about the shit we talking about. I was listening. And I was like, oh, so because so he ruined his scholarship because he got into a fight. And he was trying to help out home. No, you said no. He had a drunk mouth. I'm like, what the fuck is that, Tommy? Nothing to do with what we're talking
about. I just been making bad decisions. Yeah, it was a great story that I wanted to tell.
It's a good story.
I crowbarred it in there.
Now
I got to say it, so we're fine.
For our three viewers right now, this is just a Compas episode now. We're not talking about voting today. Yeah. I apologize.
Are we switching it up?
Yeah, it just feels like.
Sorry, everybody.
We can't be serious, man. After that, what the fuck do we do with that?
Sorry, guys.
I'll fight for you guys. I'll fight for everything we can fight for. You're my homies. I'm down for you. All right, man, but be careful. You could really like drugs, have everything,
lose your scholarship,
and work at Jack in the Box, then lose that job, then OD, then never be heard from me again. What the fuck does that have to do with fighting?
No, he heard from him just to counteract your last sentence.
No,
he
not heard after the conclusion. After the OD or not after the recovery.
I mean, I just want
think things through. I was thinking more along the lines of what TJ would and wouldn't do. And there we go.
I was just thrown off because I was like I was following the story.
Experiment time. Now let's see if we can keep it under 145. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay, fair. Now it's a normal show.
Kick it with the compass.
Yeah, boom. Here's the intro.
All right. Well, switch it to me real quick so I can intro it so I know when the cutoff is. Hey, everybody. Welcome to what was once Mongrel Radio and now is Kicking with the Compas because TJ decided to lighten the mood with homosexual spies then Tommy completely went off his own thing. There's no editing to this at all. Welcome to the show, everybody. It was a well-crafted story of tragedy.
I haven't told a good story in a while and I wanted to tell a story, Sammy. So I've made it about that.
All right, guys, welcome to Kicking with the Compas. I will be the host.
Yay, guest host, so I don't have to do anything.
Special edition.
Oh, man, this could go so much longer with Sam off the leash and just getting to have fun. We'll see.
He's pretty loose right now.
I mean, you literally did absolutely nothing to stop any one of us in that intro. So, Marcus, you gave up very quickly.
That was some gold content.
I understand letting it go. I don't know what the fuck that was.
There was no point. Because, I mean, okay, look, the conversation was flowing. And then I did try and say, hey, we'll vote you. I was given some entrances.
Right.
But then we were like, oh, hey, the fighting thing was fair. Right. I don't know what the fuck happened there.
Fighting was just an example.
It was a context.
And Tommy goes, that brings me to my next point. Don't smoke crack.
Yeah, bro, you were giving an inspirational speech about football, nigga. We play soccer. Like,
it's like, so get out there.
When you get to the goal line, get out there, make sure to kick the puck.
You know, to be fair, I do have a very accurate story about that.
I don't want to hear it anymore.
I
don't trust your endings.
It's a guy who had a friend that was just his friend from a long time.
Yeah,
his friend got drunk, called a girl names he shouldn't have called a girl in the club, got in a fight with the boyfriends, guy didn't do nothing about it.
This is the show now. You don't have to hit the fast forward. Just go.
Oh, okay.
You've ruined everything.
Well, that was it. That was the fast forward. That's probably the story I should have told in context.
What was the ending? Because I wasn't paying attention.
No. Okay. Give you some time because I got to grab another Trulies. Just tell the story.
Oh, man, I'm gonna need another one after that shit. Yeah, grab me one, please.
That's why I'm doing it.
If there's a mango one close, then grab that one. There's only four in the box.
Sorry.
It's fine. I'm almost caught up on our backlog. Sorry for being late, everybody. Work is a new thing that I'm trying to do. Work-life balance, as they call it. And I've been going out every weekend for like the last three weekends, and so I haven't had time to do that. Well, Tommy, I gave you the Twitter like last weekend, and you've posted three things.
No, I like things. I like stuff. And added people.
I actually need to go over the game plan.
They are all porn stars, surprisingly.
But hey, man, if we get an interview of a porn star, that was one of your last jobs.
Ray
last
did episodes. That. I only saw her, and I wasn't in the interview thing. I was at Mia Khalifa when Ray interviewed her.
Yeah,
that?
It was like one of the few double toasted shows I really wanted to be.
She's
on the show
fucking
for, cause
she cool.
Yeah, she's cool.
Like all things considered, so one, I learned her real name, which is like fucking dope.
Nope.
I'm not saying it.
Okay.
Oh, no, I'm not an asshole. But I learned her real name. She introduced me. I was like, oh, cool. She's fucking short. She's like this tall. She's like 5'2", maybe 5'1". Super cool. And this was right as she was making the pivot to sports media, which now she's a huge name on it, one of the biggest names in sports media. But yeah, she was super fucking cool, Mia Khalifa. And
most
just.
Stars are.
And it was just. No, but she would. But she's.
How many have you met?
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot.
Yeah. And no, but, she, no, but she's like. A1 top tier name brand, right? There's no more name brand. In 5-10 years, there's gonna be no more name brand porn stars. Like back in the day, like you know how you had your like Carmen Electra's not a porn star, but like
they still got a couple.
No, but
Jenna Jameson.
Jenna Jameson's your what are other ones?
I don't think she's made anything in.
I'm talking but back then, right?
Well, when you her heyday,
that's
yeah.
I was saying to defend you.
Yeah,
in your point that it's like
Gianna Michaels.
But those are for sex perv. Like we know because we watch porn. But like I'm talking about like mainstream,
she's a very specific,
right? Yeah.
I think part of it has to do with the death of Playboy.
Yeah, it's accessibility for sure. It's the demystifying of porn. It's the accessibility. Yeah. It's harder to be a star in it.
OnlyFans changed it completely.
Well, even before it, but even like, yeah,
because it's like now. Or now there's some amateurs video. Who do some amazing content on OnlyFans, and I'm not subscribed. But
yeah, production value the whole.
You can see from that initial image.
It's niche. It's all no, but it's all no, but they got like weird niche shit. And so if you have a thing and a thing and a thing and a thing, it compounds where you can find two, three people
that
do that, right? No, you can find two, three people that have options for your audio sensory smoking thigh fetish porn, right?
People, which means all of them are stars.
I was trying to convince the girlfriend. I was like, hey, I'll some feet pics. Get some money on this.
Dude, I'm
contributing in this bitch.
I'm size 16. Bro, I'm size 16. Do you ever think I got into the foot BBW game? Come on, man. That's come on, Jack. I don't want fucking Joe Biden all of a sudden. But like, yeah, I have these. I joke about it. I would never do it because I have flat feet. It's not attractive to them, apparently. But if I, but like, I saw in Tosh.0.
You got him on this subject.
No, it's not a subject. We're fine. Everyone watches porn. It's fine.
Well, no, porn's fine.
Are you talking about fetish stuff?
Talk about your feet.
Oh no,
I'm grossed out by feet stuff.
Oh, that's no, it's less about my feet. It's not. I'm not like Tarantino about it. But like on Tosh.0.
Hola, DMC Papa 5.
What up, man? How's it going? We're talking about my feet and crushing things with them. Well, no, Tosh.0. There was a lady that was making.
And he's gone.
Making huge money, crushing like bread, like close up on a loaf of bread, and just like stomping with her feet. And like sitting on, and then there's obviously like sitting on dudes' faces and stuff, like those twinky small guys. And then she's like, I'm gonna crush you. And then she falls on top, and people are into that shit too. I'm just saying, I'm too scared of my reputation to get into any sort of that work, even like voiceover ASMR sex work. Like,
hey, look, because the thing is, bro, they'd be like, they'd zoom into your feet, they'd be like, that black mole.
I've seen that freckle.
Gonzalez, Samuel. Oh, boom, done. That's how they find you. The internet's strong.
There was a piece of paper that had a blue ink on it. They only used that blue ink for Austin electricity bills. So we know he lives in Austin. But in that unit, there's a speckle of green, which means it was distributed to this zip code. Yeah, it's fucked up.
That
people are weird.
Unsettling.
Oh my god.
Oh,
ew. Oh, it needs to be wider.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Is that Kevin Durant's feet?
That is Kevin Durant's feet.
Why aren't they wider?
It's skeletal.
That's so weird.
Oh, Jesus, like that's like what is it, the feet binding? Like he had to have circled it up just like, to extend it out, dude.
Right. Like mine I realized are wide. I got my feet measured so I can see what my fucking feet
Yeah, I'm
fit.
Wide.
I'm a wide. And I was buying 16s, knowing I'm actually a 15 wide. So, and I was even going up to 17. So now I know what my feet are. Point is, Mia Khalifa was dope. As I would say, the last
that was as roundabout.
Yeah, we're coming back. We got to come back at least somewhere to bring it back, because else we'll just go on Kevin Durant's feet, and that shit is gross.
I don't want
to. So, yeah, she's gonna be, I think, probably one of the last of a dying breed of named porn stars. I think that there's gonna be always be some, but there's gonna be no A player. She was number one. She was top the charts, I think,
for like a while.
A good while, yeah.
Like, you know,
I mean, because
like,
she's like the only like
fetishization of Middle Eastern people post the war. And so people were like, what? They can wear hijabs and do this?
Well, she did get a lot of push in uneven right-wing media for like, oh, yeah, I'm... Because she was getting death threats from ISIS and shit.
Yeah.
So it's like, oh, yeah, I don't care. This is America. I'm free to do this.
Right. And that's fine. You know, she's in Iran. Who gives a shit, right? But, I mean, they do, of course. But like, that's for them to hash out and deal with. Don't watch porn. Fine. But... the thing about it is, like, so she had that big thing. Now there's, like, and this is fucking the dark side of TikTok that I'll find that bleeds into, like, real world and I get lost in. There's this girl that pretends to be a dog, like a puppy dog, and that's, like, a sex thing. That's fucking outrageous and
it's
weird
a girl
to
that
me.
Lives here that
Bro, why are they built like that? I think he's talking about Kevin Durant's feet.
Oh, I have a bit of a weight issue, okay? I don't know. Tommy's just elongated somehow. TJ is just naturally thick. And Marcos really tries at that shape. It's very true. But the idea is, yeah, you can just do weird sex shit. OnlyFans, a Pornhub, amateur, what do they call it? Like home or whatever, the uploads or whatever.
What?
People can make whatever type of porn they want. And nothing's going to be...
Cosplayed?
Oh, no, I'm just saying, like, you know, there's like upload feature for Pornhub where it's
I try and be as kink positive as I can. The dog one is the one where I get...
You saw that girl?
Bro, it's on Snapchat.
It's on Snapchat. Right, and it's like, it'd be one thing, it's like, okay, yeah, there's the dom sub thing, I get that, but they're like fucking restaurants doing this.
Yeah, no,
it's like,
do it in public.
Come on, man. No, not even public. Public, there's even a time and place for that, because that's part of some kink, right? If you do it in a way that's secretive.
Yeah, but the dog one is just wild to me.
Yeah, but that one was like, they're at a fucking like Subway restaurant, and there's like children around. It's like, come on, man. Yeah, like patting like a puppy, and not doing anything sexual, wearing yoga pants, and maybe like a crop top.
We're talking about the same girl.
Yeah.
I think she is from Austin.
Oh, is she from Austin?
She is from Austin.
Oh, God. Now I gotta...
I'm not Googling this.
That's... That don't... Yeah, no.
You know what? It's Sam's browser.
No! Don't do it,
bro. He already has the stuff from yesterday or the last show, dude.
So yeah,
something funny though about that girl, like,
oh, she... guilty pleasures, man. Was there porn on you guys? Guilty pleasures?
No, I'm proud of all the porn I watch. No, that's not true. I don't think that's true. Yeah,
there's a couple. Tell your grandma,
dude. That's such a weird thing. That like,
tell your grandma.
Sex and my grandma. Like, of course, you can relate. No, you can relate your parents because you were born, that they at some point did. You can come
to
terms with that.
Probably walked in on them a time or two.
Nah, they were too old by then. But.
You're lucky. You're very lucky.
I am.
Can you not make the connection between sex and...
Oh, I'm not. I'm keeping it separate. The idea is that mathematically, she's the reason why I know half of the people in my life. Just the math of it. More than half the people. So I have a big family. My grandma is the reason why I know most of the people in my life.
She created them.
Exactly. She's had to have sex at some point.
Grandma
to make that.
Having a lot of sex means
grandma
that
had eight kids.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, like
that's why
our grandparents had like fuck tons of kids.
Yeah,
that
right.
Was thing.
Right, but I never, because she's old, so I never put even that. Even
you didn't think she was ever young.
Right. Right, okay. And there's very few pictures of her at young, so
the
it's like,
the world you
man.
Live in is just blissful and naive and innocent.
Just
it's better that
it's
way.
Like, it's like he came out of a box when he was 19.
Yeah,
17.
Yeah,
17. It's true. 17.
I say, based on even the Maso Menos podcast, where the dude from your college was like, yeah, man, Sam was always awkward and like very kept to himself. And like,
no, he said my shoulders were tense.
That's the same thing.
No, shoulders. No,
I couldn't find the phrase that he used, but it's the same thing.
Anxiety is different than
high strung, uptight. Yeah,
uptight, high strung. Yeah, guilty, but like I wasn't
neurotic.
No.
Damn, who was roasting him and why wasn't I here?
Oh, no, my friend David, because like I was admitting that in college I was a bit of a dork, and David knew me when I was a bit of a dork. David is younger than me, the guy we had on the show, but he's always been cooler than me. He just kind of had his shit together, had a style, you know, and I always liked him. He's a cool guy. And he would smoke me out during those times when I did. No more, Mom. And and so, like, he would just have it there. And he's like, yeah, man, it's just good to see you, you know, chill out for a little bit, relax the shoulders. And it was just like, Marco saw that, heard that, and was like, I know that, Sam. I know that guy where I just wish I could just shake him and be like, calm the fuck down, please. And so it's the same guy that they're talking about, but he took it as like I was a dickhead somehow.
No, I didn't say you were a dickhead. The uptight does not mean you're a dickhead.
Uptight awkward. People are kind of dickheads, to be honest. Awkward, yes.
Yeah.
But not look, but not like a like a choir boy like you guys think I was.
If this was a show, he would be the lead in the show. He's Ted Mosby. Like,
oh hell yeah, dog.
Oh yeah,
that's him. We would Who's be the cookie? Co-stars.
Wait, Ted Mosby. No, that was another Mosby from Ned's Survival Guide. I got that convinced. I got that confused. You know about Ned's Survival Guide? It was Ned Mosby.
Hang on, man. I'm cookie because I end up okay. with the glow up girl.
Fair enough. But Ted Mosby, Ned Mosby, forgive me, guys. Yeah,
no.
But anyway.
But yeah, no, you're Ted Mosby 100%, dog.
100%.
Yeah.
Bro.
Oh, damn.
Ted Mosby, him and JJ, Marshall and Lily, dog.
Yeah.
Boom. Wait, Marshall and Lily are him and JJ? Not him and Jeff?
There's not a lot of guy shows, bro. You would have to go to the league.
So then are you Neil Patrick Harris?
I'm sorry. Jess is a redhead, as is Lily. He's a big dude like Marshall.
Big and kind of frumpy.
Did you not make those?
I was just like, hey, I was trying to do with the host.
He was trying to find JJ. And then the problem is with all these shows is they're about two couples,
yeah.
Really.
Yeah.
How I Met Your Mother. JJ's Rob. Scrubs.
Yeah.
There's six friends, but I hate all of them.
Always. Yeah. Always. Like, yeah.
Hey, Arnold. I could be Arnold.
They No, no Arnold's cool too enough. Cool, dude. Yeah. Oh, bro, that bro is smooth. Cool.
I don't know, man. He choked when Lila liked him or didn't like him.
Bro,
he choked, man. He got nervous.
The thing was, bro, you know him and the black dude be dapping, bro. He's cool.
Okay,
he's
that's cool. Fair. He's from the New York hood.
Bro, he's from the streets, dead ass, like like inner city streets.
Lives in a boarding house. His elementary school's numbered. It doesn't even have a name. PS 118.
Yeah.
Why I committed that to memory?
Yeah,
don't know.
Public school 118, baby. Mm-hmm. Like, dead ass. He like, Arnold's too cool for you.
What are other white cartoon characters that are invited to
Doug,
the cookout?
Doug.
I am. Doug is
good.
Oh,
wait. Invited to the cookout.
Yeah, white cartoon characters that are invited to the cookout. So, Arnold in the fucking intro, it does dap up.
Bro,
Gerald.
Daps up. Yep.
Yeah. Arnold is it.
Arnold.
TJ from Recess, I think.
TJ's scheming, bro.
TJ? Any of the Ed brothers?
No. Bro, they be like, niggas be like, them niggas weird.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah.
Let's see. What? Yeah,
there ain't
good,
many.
White cartoon characters. There's a lot of white cartoon characters.
Tons.
Yeah.
Johnny Quest hangs out with an Indian dude.
No,
that doesn't work that way.
I'm just saying, man. I'm throwing it out there. I'm just throwing out different white characters I can think of.
I mean,
Tommy Pickles? Half Jewish, half white. No, but like when he comes a teenager at one point.
No, he ain't cool like that. But cool. I would say like, I mean,
he's a baby.
Like he wouldn't get invited to the cookout, but he would be the nigga who shows up with like a black girl. Would be Johnny Bravo. Like, he could make it in. Yeah. Like you wouldn't send him an invite, but you'd be like, oh, that's Denisha's cousin. I mean, that's Denisha's husband. He's good.
Hello there, Nubian mama.
Yeah, like literally
say some shit like that. It's like, oh, is that racism? Is saying Nubian? No, okay, I think we're fine.
Those guys exist.
Yeah, Nubian's proper, right? Like, you can't. Yeah, I can say
like
that, right?
White
Nubian is the proper way to say. Yeah,
Snoopy.
Mahogany Prince.
Oh, yes. Bobby.
Who?
What?
Bobby Hill.
Bobby Hill invited to the cookout. Propane
yeah,
accessories.
He's pretty
Bobby,
cool.
Yeah, Bobby can make it.
I'm trying to think. I don't know. That's a good question. I don't know.
Somebody said Fred.
Fred,
get out of here.
Fred.
Fred ain't making it.
Fred
from Flintstones?
Yeah. No, from Scooby Doo.
No, fuck no.
Shaggy might.
Shaggy
high
bring,
as fuck.
He don't bring that shit.
Right.
Yeah.
Hey, bro,
he's gonna have to leave school because black people are afraid. Some
somebody
black
was
people are
was
afraid
talking
of
about like
yeah.
So Scooby Velma talks, is now Asian in the new thing.
Yes.
I think
I thought she was Hispanic.
No,
no Velma. K-League is
Daphne is gonna be yeah. black. I'm sorry, bro. I don't know if that's good or bad for you.
Sure. Why not?
Who cares?
But it's like as the story progresses, they're like. But Shaggy always needs to be white. Like, it doesn't matter.
It becomes super racist if he doesn't.
Whatever.
if you make him a Mexican. Oh, pothead Mexican.
Yeah. He's the next.
Right.
Like, it's that awakening moment that everybody has, and you're like, oh, Shaggy's a stoner.
Right.
He's a hippie. You have to keep him with
peace
you.
And love.
Bro, as soon as he said, as soon as, like he was vegetarian from the get-go. He's vegetarian, canonically.
They eat a lot of sandwiches.
Those sandwiches
there was one series where, like, he was straight up vegetarian.
There has to be one.
A million series.
But I think, like, a lot of them, like, that became, like, a character trait. Like, because he was peace, love, all
so
that kind of shit.
They made a canon now. So
yeah. I'm pretty sure he put a slice of ham on one of them
what
sandwiches.
Makes it unfun.
With the bone in it when they cut it.
I don't give a fuck. The combinations of shit they used to put together used to make me hungry as fuck.
Oh, the Scooby's next sandwich?
Well,
because
they'd
like,
be like, it's starting off like, hey, I'm going to need a little peanut butter, jelly, chocolate chips, turkey, chicken breast. Lettuce, mayo,
right. Cookies,
yeah,
right.
And then of course top it off with some Scooby snacks. And then they do the olive like with the sand.
I thought of another one. Who's Max's friend from Goofy Movie? The one with the Leaning Tower of Chisa.
Oh, that nigga. Hey, no, all of them.
Is he
black?
White?
No,
all of them is white.
He has white hair.
No, Goofy Movie is a black movie.
Black.
That's a black movie, but
Goofy's black.
Is Pete black?
They said Goofy is black.
We've established this.
It's established by Disney.
But no, but the orange, black. But the guy with the orange hair, he's got to be the only white guy in the whole movie.
No, he's still black.
He's still black. He's albino.
Bro,
what you got?
He's light skinned.
I don't know.
What was it too? It's all black. Whatever that species is in Disney, those are black. Well,
they're all dogs, I think.
There you go. They can go to the Pride family reunion. It's all the same.
True.
Proud family. Yeah. You said Pride family.
Proud family.
I mean, the Pride family is that one. Spy show that we saw in the pre-show.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
The Pride family.
There was nothing here. It started showing anime people, and I'm like, that's a different conversation.
Yeah. Wait, anime people that were invited to the cookout?
I would say that, you know, like, yeah, I'm trying to think of, like, that's kind of hard to think of, like, characters to be invited to the cookout, but that's kind of sad just because I guess they just don't make...
They don't make them.
Don't make them.
They don't make them.
Don't make cool... Or maybe we just don't
want... The Travis Kelce...
The Travis Kelce cartoon cartoons.
Yeah,
bro.
That should be a top five side characters you'd invite to your house. Like Mr. Wynn from Hey Arnold. He's a country singer. Guy seems cool as fuck.
We're talking about like side characters or like in live action and not live action?
I'm talking about cartoons.
Oh, because I was about to say Mr. Feeny.
I mean, that would be fun, too.
Mr.
Feeny's right.
Mr. Minotza.
You know I would invite Topanga.
That's where this conversation goes, which is why I would not
Tommy,
put
it. You ruin everything, man.
It was excellent.
Topanga is excellent. She was. She missed my list. She missed my list on the crushes, the 90s crushes.
I think she was a JJ's.
She was the 90s crush for me.
Yeah. But like, she's like 16. You can't invite a 16-year-old to dinner. You have to do it in canon. You're going to pick college age.
She's older than all of us.
No, but you can't just. That's just an actress.
Topanga would be.
Because she still looks the same.
Well, yeah, there's also. The other continuation, College. Girl Meet Next Door.
Girl Meets World?
Yeah.
time out. When you think about the characters, we're trying to think about them in the way of, like, if you were that age. Like, I mean, like, hey, like, why would you...
They age why would
I? Why would I invite Arnold to the crib? Nigga's a kid.
He's a cool-ass kid.
That's they don't
a
care
special me. Episode of Hey Arnold. Don't do that.
Yeah, don't
no,
do that.
No, that was another Arnold, and that was Gary Coleman.
Yeah.
And a bicycle was involved.
Yeah, yeah. It's like,
I hope the TV people who think I don't watch shit get that joke because that was excellent.
That's a whole montage.
It was an Arnold joke.
It's a whole countdown on YouTube.
It was a molestation joke.
You know, when you explain it out, it stops being funny.
I know, but they don't know. And I knew you guys know.
Yeah, but they don't know, which makes it.
I know, which makes it frustrating that I'm so brilliant.
Or maybe they probably know.
If they don't know, now they know. I can't say that word.
Where else is this train going? Jesus,
it goes wherever.
I mean,
says
Tommy,
the guy who told a story about drugs leading up to a fight that never happened.
I told you the fight, the condensed version of the fight story.
I think that
don't
you know,
be like Kyle, everybody.
Sam, okay, when's the last time you got in a fight?
Yeah.
If
like an actual fist fight?
Yeah. When,
I'm good at deflating them. That's the thing.
I'm a conflict resolution.
But last one was in high school. It was before practice. I was just minding my own business. Big ass dude had a sunflower seeds. I'm minding my business. Starts spitting the sunflower seeds on me. I'm like, and I thought first one was an accident, second one, whatever. Third one's like, all right, motherfucker.
Before practice?
Before practice. Like before
so you're
football
in the
practice.
Locker room.
This is outside. We're waiting. I don't know why we were outside. We were we had just put pads on. But we got the shoulder pads off.
But still, you were in shorts.
We had the football pants on. shirt. You know, there are just bare shirts.
I just want to know, like, were this dude sunflower seeds in his ass? Like, where did the fuck did they come from?
I don't fucking know either. He was just eating sunflower seeds. Whatever. He's one of them bad kids that...
Maybe he just had them in his hand when he's coming up the block.
Yeah.
One of those.
Yeah, but we were, like, hanging out, waiting for... I think this was, like, two... Like, something happened. And he does a third time, and I'm like, hey, man, what the fuck's that about? And then I'm like, do that again. Then he spit him in my face. So I shoved him. He threw a punch. I threw a punch, and... The cops, the coaches started coming, and then we just kind of broke it up. And then, like, we practiced, and then the coach was like, what the fuck was that? I was like, man, he's acting like a fucking idiot, man. And then I just did what I had to do. We're good. It's done. But I was fucking heated, dude. I was just like, that was the last time I was gotten in a fight. It was this little skirmish.
Did you win?
See, you know,
it was a draw. He gave me a black eye.
That's not a real fight.
I don't get into real fights because nobody wants to fight me. I'm good at defusing, and. No, I know how to fight well enough, and then the people who really want to fight, I know how to defuse them because they're stupid. What's up?
You stop it. You were chimed up. He was like, I know how to fight well enough. Marco was ready.
No, I didn't say
Marco
it.
Was cocked up. I said, no, come on.
I didn't say anything. Nor do I.
Are you trying to fight Marcos? You want to fucking throw down, motherfucker?
That's not what he meant.
You want to fight, motherfucker?
Now he has something to prove. Thanks, Marco.
Yeah, you fucker. No, I don't have nothing to prove.
He already wants to deadlift more than people at Big Tags, and that's.
Oh yeah, that was fun. We can cut back to that.
what I was saying was that actually makes me think of, like, it's so funny how, like, in a football setting, how coaches handle things versus, like, how teachers and, like,
it's completely different.
Yeah, because in it's as if there's a barrier when you're still in the school system, but there's a barrier when you're amongst the coaches.
Mm-hmm.
They're like, shit, we got to let shit slide. Because it'd be like, oh, look, if that happened, shoot, they just make you run burpees.
run burpees.
Make you do burpees.
Up, down,
make, make you do fucking make. We used to have this thing. We had bleachers, right?
Like, yeah.
Like, and you just run up and down the bleachers.
Yep.
Ours was miles.
We had to run the reservoir.
Bro,
empty reservoir. It's just, it's like a
we had miles run up and that bleachers. Shit. Yeah.
But.
Because we had, but that's the whole thing. It's just like, yeah, like. But it would never make it to the school system.
Yeah.
Never. Oh, if bad things happen, bro, it'd be like, hey, shoot, shut up. It's
handled in-house.
Yeah.
It would keep it moving.
Yeah, that situation was more of a square up, threw a couple punches, and it was done, whatever, right?
Yeah, no, then later, in the locker room, your coach will, you know.
But
yeah,
then later.
Our coach was all about, like, you're going to the locker room, and we're closing the door, and
handle it.
See you in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Right. And then later, that same motherfucker got in a fight with one of our defensive end on the bus. Like, they just, I don't know what it was. That guy just wanted to fight somebody. He's a little gangster kid. He thought he was tough. He wasn't an actual gang. If you're a gangster guy in high school and you're in school, then you're not a gangster. I just want you to know that, kids out there. Or if you're in football, you're not a gangster. You can't gangbang and play recreational sports. Were you gangbanging and playing recreational sports?
I said it was me.
I'm just saying.
Hey, man. Hey, look, you got. Hey, I don't even blame him, bro. Hey, pocket your money one way or the other. Either you get the scholarship or you buy. Hey, cool, you got an industry.
Now, I'm not talking about, like, selling drugs. I'm talking about, like, shooting people. That's in the area that we were at. That's what we did.
Did all those things.
Aaron Hernandez did. But then the follow up,
just so I can finish the story, I took both of their starting positions. I was not a starter that day, and I took both their starting positions because one, he was left tackle, and the other one was defensive tackle. And then I got, like, so much work that day. It was fun. Won that game. Stopped the goal line by myself. It was great. Like, fourth and one, jammed the gap, fucking great. Won the game for us.
You finished with your stroke fest?
Yep. I had to finish. I mean, half these stories of me getting my ass beat, so I had to start somewhere where I was winning, but go ahead.
You didn't get beat up in one of these fights that you told today.
I didn't tell those stories. It's my own personal backlog stories I'm never going to tell you guys. Actually, I've never been beaten up.
How old you were?
I was 16.
Last time you got beat.
Oh, that was the last time I got punched. I've never been beaten up.
Then what are you?
I think that's why I act the way I act, because I've never been really beaten up.
Oh, never had your ass whooped. That explains a lot. Actually.
Like, my brother messed with me. I had cousins that messed with me.
No, we're talking about a complete stranger.
Nah, you've been babied up, bro.
Oh, a stranger with nothing to lose? I'm too good at bobbing and weaving, and I'm too good at defusing fights.
You think you are until you're actually in the situation.
Dude, I've been in the situation. Like, a guy got one soft punch off.
That should
be the last fight you win.
That was 16.
Motherfucker, you were 30.
Yeah. Good record. Good head movement.
We're not downplaying the fact you haven't gotten to fights. Actually, that's respectful.
Thing.
It's commendable.
Super respectful.
Yeah.
It's
especially when people want to pick fights. That's the problem, guys, that you're not getting, is that people want to pick fights with me all the time. It's annoying.
I literally mind my own business and homeless people attack me. So shut the fuck up. I get that.
No, that's just because you're black, unfortunately. This is racist.
Nigga a million times.
Racist homeless people are a problem here.
The homeless guy was black.
I mean,
you can still be racist. Still come on, you can still be racist.
He was not, but oh, not the, well, one of them was.
Well, that was. I'm sorry that you have random like side scroller bosses when you walk the streets of Austin, just minding your own business. Hey, do they come with a broken bottle, trying to jab at you.
I'm rolling my eyes when I see the versus screen, dog. I'm like, shit.
Fucking the double dragon theme starts playing. Shit.
But no, I just. It's one of those things where, like,
king of the fight, all of a sudden.
Where it's just always, it's funny to be like, hey, like, excuse me, because in a way, right?
Yeah.
The reason why we're laughing about it is just because, hey, man, you just haven't got your ass beat,
right?
And it's fine,
right?
You haven't got your ass beat,
yeah. It's not a bad.
But you've always been a big dude, so you have that safety net,
that, right? But the thing is that everyone always wants to try to beat me up, and I'm just really good at scaring people. It's like, what's your tactic?
When's the last time someone tried to beat you up?
That wanted to fight me?
Yes.
God, it was here.
In the complex?
No, it was in Austin somewhere. No, it wasn't. So in the last 5 years, it didn't happen
it
that
was
much.
His ex-girlfriend.
No. That's rude. That's rude.
That's why I didn't name her.
I know. That's rude, though. Don't say that. And not true for the sake of air. I don't want to embarrass nobody that doesn't need to be embarrassed. God damn it. Somebody odd sixth. I bumped into them by accident and they got loud and they squared up. And I'm just like, and I, this was the easy A mode type of thing. It's like, man. Calm down, man. You want an apology? Fine. I'm sorry. There. You good? And then they just like, yes. And then they walk away. Like, that's really all it takes. That is the lowest tier. But he did square up. He did shove me. And it's like,
all
right.
So I know all Sixth Street nights are a blur. Like, uh-huh. There's literally like no way to. You're probably going to know this. But still, what bar was it?
Probably Shakespeare or that Blind Pig Shakespeare area.
Last time we were there, you almost got shot. So
that was last weekend.
I'm just
weekend.
Saying it's the same block.
Oh yeah, yeah. Sixth
like,
Street.
Don't go to that block.
Oh no, it's fine. Yeah, I mean, I'm fine.
It's the highlight of Sixth Street. Really.
I could be anywhere, and people try to shoot. I mean, it's the way the world.
If you ask,
just
if you
don't
ask,
go to Sixth Street.
If you ask Ray, it's mugshots.
but TJ, how do you defuse? Because I have my levels. You guys saw step one. I have about two more levels beyond that. How do you defuse fights other than just, hey man. Chill out. And then most people, I feel like, would be disarmed by that.
I'm naturally a cool person, so once they get to... And I'm pretty rational and articulate, so when you throw big words at someone at an escalation, they're like... I'm like, hey, man...
You're being superfluous. Damn, I couldn't even say it.
Yeah, I'd be like, hey, I see that this is a trepidatious scenario that we're in.
Trepidatious.
Let's keep it cool. Keep it copacetic. And they'll be right. Yeah, sure. I'm like, oh, cool.
Yeah.
But then also a lot of times, so I'm also not small either. So it's like, if I check, like, and I'm not like, and even, and the thing is like, if, even when I'm smaller, like that just shows more. So I'm just like, cool. Right. So it really is like a matter of combination of me being a friendly person and a bigger person.
Right.
To where they're just like, okay, cool.
Yeah.
But a lot of the times in terms of like there's been plenty of fights. Shoot. Last time I was up in D-Town, me and my, I was chilling with Cosmo and like his neighbor, and they got beef. Motherfucker came up.
They got actual beef against neighbors.
Yeah, motherfucker came up and Cosmo was like, call the cops. I said, hell no. Like, so I had to go defuse. I was like, hey, yo. And then you defuse that scenario. So it's just like whenever I come up, I always take the note. I know the tonality. I use a lot of debate tactics, and I just make sure that everything is good.
He's got that ready.
I mean, it ain't wrong.
That's the next fight. But no. So, what are your tactics? Do people try to fight you? You seem to mind your business, Tommy.
I do very, very much mind my business, which is the best way to do things.
Right.
But I've had situations probably within the past few years where you know something could have popped off.
Right.
But no, I defuse shit just by. Kind of TJ's tactic, just always.
Well, because the thing is, people come up
slowly
and be like, yeah.
And calm, and like I'm not stressing.
You guys are better than me, then.
They just look because they look at us and they're like, "Yo, they want you to be mad
they
and
do.
Yelling."
Killing people with kindness is a very effective thing.
But the other thing is like also, hey man, nothing beats cool black guy tone. They're like, damn, this guy's cool.
Cool black guy tone is pretty great.
Because
I will say that
because you can know when someone's like, hey, that's a good dude.
Yeah,
and you're like, fuck. And then once you have that rationalization,
right? There's nothing more disarming than a black guy saying, "Hey, man, be cool."
And I legitimately, I was dancing on some dude's girlfriend because she didn't tell me his girlfriend.
Oh shit!
That was her boyfriend.
I've been there before.
The dude came up. He was like, "Hey, man, that's my girlfriend." I said, "Hey, man, it's all good." He was like, "Oh, cool." I was like, "Walked off. That's lit.
Well, yeah. I mean, you're clearly in the wrong. They got to have a conversation. Yeah, that's not a you thing.
Shit.
That's not a you thing.
Hey, my bad.
See, I don't have that luxury because I'm just so massive. You might. Well, but also, Tom, you know me. Any chance I could shit talk?
Yes.
That's my problem.
Yes, we know you.
So I've been able to weaponize it to where I get other people involved. So step one is like, look.
What?
Yeah, watch. Listen. Yeah, listen. It's a part of the plan. It's worked flawlessly every time.
Sammy, the way that I visualized that in my head was like, I involve other people. So you'd be getting ready to squirrel. He's like, hey, I was the only one talking shit. That nigga looking at Tommy was also talking.
No, I'm trying
to find a path.
It's
here,
even worse. No, it's even worse because I know my situational awareness is really good. So I always know who and what's involved in what groups, right?
Okay.
First thing, so they try to square up, they push me. Because my dad, actually I want to backtrack to this, why I'm the way I am. My dad was a small ass motherfucker. What?
We don't have all day.
I know, no we don't. It's very simple. My dad was a small motherfucker, grew up in the projects. Had to fight his way out the projects. He had this rule where if you pushed him twice, he'd sock you in the fucking face. Okay. That's how he had to live. So push me once, whatever. He goes, they put their hands out, sock him in the face, it's on. Right. They would say, do you want to get in a fight with somebody? Go find Gilbert. That's my dad's reputation. Okay. So he trained me to have a chip on my shoulder all the time when it comes to fighting.
That's obvious.
Very obvious. If you wonder why sometimes it feels like I have a small man mentality when it comes to shit, it's because my dad gave that to me as a little bit of that chip on my shoulder. Okay. So when people come to fights, talk some shit or whatever, it's usually first thing is, hey, man, chill out, all right? It's usually like I'm not usually conceding. I'm not soft talking. I'm just like, hey, calm the fuck down. It's all right. Whatever. And then we go talk. Then they try to escalate. If they escalate to that second tier, the next phrase is, man, you don't want none of this. Shut the fuck up. Get out of my face. It's all right. You can walk away. Be fine. If you want some of this, it ain't going to be cheap. I usually say something along those lines. If they keep yapping, this is the third tier and the final tier where I get other people involved. And pardon my cadence. I'm going to get a little loud. Headphone listeners, be careful. I look them dead in the eye. Get crazy eyes. I go, all right then, make a fucking move then. Make a move. Fucking crazy.
Which tier is this? Three?
This three. This is loud.
You realize this could be less than a minute of conversation to get to this
point. Yeah, it's literally 10 to 30 seconds.
That's a good strategy.
It is, because once I do that, everyone's eyes go center, because I go from zero to fucking loud, and I'm not doing anything, because my hands are out. I go, fine then. Right?
I feel like that could backfire.
Because my thing is,
but if it goes to that point, then I'm fighting and it's fine. I've accepted that. When I say that, when I get to that point, I do.
You've been in a fight since you were 16.
Because here's the assessment that I make. I'm ready to, but I never have to. You know why? Because there's usually in the group of people, because they're out, some girl that knows the guy that wants to fight, because that's usually how it goes. So when I get loud, I look big and scary, bearded, bald, giant, usually taller than the motherfucker. Their girls usually go, no, stop, and they walk in front of their man and start pushing them back as soon as I do that. And then as soon as they do that, I take a step back, because I don't want to fight, because I'm not about that life. I'm not a tough guy. But they always do that, and then since I'm taking a step back, that's their out, and they take it every time. No one's gonna push past a woman. And if they push past a woman, then I have a reason to beat their ass, and then be like, yeah, he hit his girl.
You are hoping for a lot of variables.
There's no what. Someone shoots me, they're gonna shoot me anyway. It's fine. That's how I live my fucking life nowadays.
Someone can whoop your ass very.
That's
easily.
Fine. Bro, that's fine.
If I gauge that this is the type of nigga who's gonna shoot, hey nigga, just punch me. I'm good.
Right.
I am
good. But if they beat my ass, then so what? You take the ass beating. That's life, baby.
What a fun thing to tell.
I'm ready for it. That's part of the chip on the shoulders. That if you're going to get into a fight, one of the options of the two is you're going to get your ass beat.
Yeah.
So if someone's going to fight,
my thing
then
is,
fight.
You don't. I want to. My thing is, he can. It's other ways to handle.
Yeah.
I just want to pause, Sam, just for a little bit.
Yeah.
Just because
I would like to hear
you've talked for 4 minutes at least.
That's fine.
Maybe longer.
Right.
It's monologue. TJ does it all the time. I did editing.
He doesn't. Go ahead.
He does. But
thank you.
Just
I feel
just,
very unnecessarily attacked.
I tried.
Dickwad.
Just the Sims.
I can say no. I can say Jack Diddley shit if you want me to. I mean, if you really want me to be stopped. Actually, you know what you want to. I'm kidding.
Was it like you were on the fucking recorded shows all last year? Bam! We're all being spicy today.
All right, stop.
Let's go, Marco.
You ain't never seen me actually ticked off.
If I could pause Sam's mic right now, I would. But that being said, so I wanted to talk to you about this.
What's up?
So Sam has gotten really spicy, really chip on his shoulder every time he's gone out the last couple of times.
What happened last time?
Yeah.
What happened with floating?
Nothing happened with floating.
Oh, because I was talking about
we're drunk.
After that.
What happened?
Oh, yeah, I did.
Okay.
That's fine.
So Sam has been very, very much on the hunt. There's nothing wrong with that. He's been a single dude for a while.
Yep. Yeah, I know. Me too, brother.
Yeah, hold on.
I think I'm empty, guys.
So last time he stepped into somebody's yard, and he might have not done anything. He just was... just kept talking about the other yard.
Mm-hmm. The yard?
It's a euphemism.
Okay.
Tommy gets it.
Yeah. Got it.
I just think with this strategy and with that going on, it only doubles that you're going to be in a fight by the end of July.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And it's hot.
And people have been just stuck inside with a lot of black Air Force energy afoot.
All right, so carry me out. All right, then. That's all I ask. Get me out of danger so people don't stomp on me. I'll take the dive. I'll fall. I'll break my jaw, break my teeth. I got good insurance. In July, I got insurance then. Just make sure that they don't get a chance to crack my ribs while I'm already beaten. That's all I ask.
I need some context.
To drag my lifeless corpse out?
You've explained this already.
Bro, if you went up to somebody, like hypothetically, right? You went up to someone
with Kyle.
And if you disrespected someone or you did something to where I'm like, damn, he's in the wrong, I'm going to leave you on the ground for a little bit, like, damn, nigga, you fucked up.
That's fine. But
then I'll move you. I'm going to move you, but I have questions.
I'm just saying, save my ribs. That's all I'm saying. I don't want to broke my rib.
I have like a mental, like, imagination that he's gonna get uppercutted off your boat next week.
Uppercutted? Nobody can pull an uppercut off on me.
It's a cartoon, Sam. I'll give you that.
So fine. Then use the appropriate term. Sure you can. If I get sure you can off his boat, that's more plausible than me being uppercutted, classic style.
I just think that okay.
So for one, boats are the kind of boat that I'm imagining is his party barge. It's
pontoon boat, are they called?
They are slippery. It's not...
I've been on one, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but also, once again, situational awareness. If I can't get my feet down, if it's like a goddamn Disney cartoon with a floor full of bananas, I'm not going to pick a fight there. Also, I'm drinking. I'm having a good time. What am I going to be doing there?
That's exactly
why we think that would happen.
Oh, no. If it becomes
a sea of opportunities and other people's yards, I'm just saying there's a chance.
I'm also, at the same time, not a vibe ruiner. That's also a huge key for me.
It sounds to me like you're ready to ruin vibes.
In three easy steps.
You laid out the informational guide.
The vibes are when the fights start. If I get to that point where the girl's like, stop fighting, then it's like, okay.
What if she doesn't exist?
They always exist.
No!
When have
they
you been?
Don't.
What parties and places you're going to where there's no girls there?
No,
there
in a group.
There are girls there.
Right. It doesn't mean that
one
any
of
their boyfriends.
The motherfucker that's about to fight me has a girlfriend.
No, but
clearly,
but even the friends
fights,
of the friends of the friends.
Have you done this on Sixth Street? Because girls are not going to chime in and be like...
A lot, most don't.
Bro, yes.
I haven't been in any situation where that shit's happened.
Hell no.
I'm in them all the time.
Bro,
because I'm big and scary. Because I'm big and scary.
No.
I'm bigger, taller than you. I'm not stronger or anything like that. But I'm bigger than you. And I'm bigger than
it's
you.
It's all a facade. We know.
It's exactly.
But no, my whole thing is like, you know that with your bigness and tallness, you could be the big, tall, and cool dude.
I am.
You still get the same goddamn effect.
I am. But people want to fuck with me. And I'm not going to be fuck-wittable. If people want to fuck with me and get away with this scot-free, because if I'm in the wrong,
I'm not fuck-wittable.
If I'm dancing on someone's girl, all right. That's my bad. I didn't know. Walk away. You're cool. But if someone is an accident, I bump into them. Yeah, I'll apologize or whatever. But if they want to be tough about some shit, then be tough about some shit and fight.
So
and then, but usually the vibe and the people don't want the fight to happen.
So let's
and
say
so that means
you dance
to
with another person's girl.
Happens all the time.
And he pushes you.
Uh-huh.
You're not going to ruin the vibe.
I'm just going to be like, hey, what the fuck was that? Hey, that's my girl, man. Well, I didn't fucking know that. And then this is up to him to be like,
I've been in a lot of situations where it's just push and 3 seconds later is the punch.
Well if he pushes, if he's asking me some shit, then he's not punching.
Dude,
if he pushes,
I'm not used to people asking.
All right, all right. So if he pushes
you think
and
the
then
the homeless dude asked me my opinion.
No, no. So if he's pushing and then cocking his hand back and rushing, then I know since he pushed me, it's time to throw a straight jab. Because people don't throw jabs anymore. Let's be honest. Unless they're like MMA fucking fighters. People throw haymakers all the time still. Like, people are sloppy fighters unless they're MMA people, which that's more common now, which is fucking scary. But most people don't know how to fight proper. People like fighting. They street fight. And so if they're trying to throw a punch, a lot of drunk bar people, especially drunk, are going to throw it wide. So you duck, straight shot. If they're MMA fuckers, they're going to dive at your legs, then I'm done. Then it's ground and pound, and I have no defense for that. I'm a boxer. I'm a boxer. I'm not an MMA guy. Well, so if you see me, if you see my legs get taken out, help. Help me.
That's not the strategy that almost any normal fighter would use.
The whole thing. The whole point is we ain't trying to get you to a fight. The thing is.
No, I'm just
your
saying.
Your three steps should be. Here, you want to know my three.
Stop, collaborate, listen, sure,
this
whatever.
No,
okay, so look. Here are my three steps. If de-escalation off the first rip don't work, which it never usually does, because I'm a salesman, dog. I can sell to whatever, right?
Right.
But if step one is the initial, like, hey, good, da-da-da-da, right? Step two is when I get into the real conflict. Step three, nigga, ain't nobody turning down a free drink. Just be like, hey, man, hey, I'll buy some drinks. We'll check it. Hey, like, forget it ever happened. We good. Like...
Yeah,
and
that's
then,
not in Sam's wheelhouse. Too.
I mean,
not even
like,
close.
Like,
no, and it's like, cool. $10 saves y'all both $100 in fixing your shit.
But if
minimum.
If it benefits me, if he's got like cool, if he seems like a cool dude, just misunderstanding, then maybe.
How are you gonna make that judgment?
Exactly.
In three seconds?
I won't.
Angry.
Yeah.
yeah. I won't. Trying to make that judgment crunk.
All right.
It's not gonna happen.
So guess what? Looks like that judgment has been made for me that I gotta fight somebody now because they pushed me.
It didn't have to be this
because
way,
they pushed me. No, but why is someone putting their hands on me? Why are they pushing me? I mean,
because
there's different reasons.
You were dancing on their girl.
Yeah, so there's different reasons, right? And I didn't know. Sorry, bro. If that's not enough, what the fuck do they want?
That's not what you said,
fine,
man.
Fine. I didn't fucking know. All right. Is that not enough?
That's aggressive.
What the fuck do they need to know? They want a fucking handwritten apology? Is that what they want? Do you want me to get on a knee and bow in front of them like a gentleman?
We want you to be cool.
No, I'm talking about them.
No, it's the same.
Same.
No,
thing.
Fuck that. Why do I gotta be cool when they're acting like a dickhead? You know, that's that minimalist shit where it's like, oh, you need to be smaller so other people can. Because you know who's gonna push me? Ain't no Mexican
totally
barely push me.
Getting into a fight by the end of this.
Yeah, let's fuck.
Oh,
I'm gonna get into a fight. I'm gonna go find one. Let's go do it.
Hey, pool. Want to see how long it takes?
Hey, bro,
mid-July me.
I'm oh shit, dog. Mid-July. I'm gonna say like I'm gonna actually put some days to it. Maybe like the 23rd, 24th.
That's
like
too
that.
Specific. It's too specific. We need windows.
Oh, windows, fine. I'll take last week and then into the first week of August.
Nice, Marco. You.
And then I'll go visit my niece with a black eye. It's cool,
Marco.
It's cool.
When is this son of a bitch gonna get in a fight? Because it's
so.
Coming.
Do I have a week?
Oh damn!
No, I'm just.
Oh, okay.
He's making roulette rules where you can black out a whole week. You can pull out even numbers.
No,
odd numbers.
I imagine a pool like when you block a calendar.
Yeah, kind of like split a month up in three parts.
I took last.
Well, we want to give JJ. A
JJ
part.
Wants
that's
some of this
weeks.
Action. Let's be honest.
Okay, so I'll take last week.
Summer's just started.
I'll take the week of his party.
And if I don't get into a fight, if I successfully avoid all fights,
you owe no favors to them.
No, don't throw my favorite out.
Okay, I'm sorry.
What was your favorite again?
I haven't told you.
Okay, fair
you
enough.
Don't know. I don't need you.
Motherfucker, I say yes to everything you ask of me. Shut up.
You do?
Act like I haven't said that or I've not done anything for you.
That's not
you're like
what
my favorite person.
That's
I fucking
not
like
I
you,
said.
Dog.
Never been
I think you're I think you're fucking cool. I appreciate the things you do for me. You're a great friend and you're a great listener,
don't
you son
talk
of a bitch.
To him like that.
See, talk about defusing a situation and keeping your.
No, I felt attacked. Yeah. I was like, "Hey, man, the reason I'm asking you for shit is because I'm not. I mean, you know, I'm not that type of person."
Right, but when you do, the rare times, you know, I'm there.
No, you never should know.
You can call.
I just said, don't throw my favor away. That's all I said.
And you know,
hey, well, bro, wherever. You're a complex guy, Sam. You're a great friend.
Hell yeah, I am.
But you have a short fuse, apparently, if you're out and about.
Bro, you know what?
Shorter than you guys get. Because you guys get a lot, to be honest.
Do
yeah. I used to, dude, I grew up in Fresno, California. You talk about this heat? It's 110 every fucking summer since the day I was born, man.
Where all this come from heat?
Summer's hot, dry heat, dehydration makes you aggressive. That's true. You mentioned
from
it.
Texas.
Right. It's humid, and you guys are fine.
No one has ever said humid.
Why are you so mad?
No one
it's
has
because
ever
you're
said
angry. Now, this shit got me heated. You want to talk about heated?
That's accurate.
That's accurate.
Yeah, you guys are all dumb men. It's fine. I get it.
This and where can I give him money?
So this is the gym we'll be going to probably on Sunday.
Yeah, because I need to get a gym day in.
Is it open?
And I'm going to wear my Cali
you
shit.
You can go for a day.
$10 or something like that.
Yeah. Really? Yeah. And
big tax.
Yeah. No, we're going to Lyft because they have that flag and we thought it would be
we
funny.
We got to see
them. They just put that up.
Sorry.
I follow them.
I didn't know if they good. I didn't know if big
they
tech
deserve to be
I
followed.
Yours.
No, I just thought because of the murals at Lyft, like
Lyft
outside
is dope.
Lyft is a pretty okay, well then you already know about it.
But show the people so they get some context.
So,
show the rest of them, or not.
Lyft posted this. Well, I'll go back to that. Yes. Lyft posted this about a couple days ago. It's like, dude, we chose violence today. And then they started an argument where somebody brought up that so they've had strongman competitions at Lyft between Team In-N-Out and Team Whataburger. And he's like, Team Whataburger smoked them all the time.
Right.
Sam took it as a challenge and was
wait,
like,
is that a real thing? Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't know that was a real thing. But yeah, that's fun. If it's a real thing, then sure. Out of spite, I'm going to try to deadlift more just so that flag can be shown some goddamn respect.
You're going
to
hurt yourself.
I don't give a shit. If it costs me my knees, my spine, my coccyx.
Definitely not worth that shit.
It's worth proving a point. That's the thing,
a
Tommy.
Point that what? It's
Tommy,
not that good?
The difference between me and you guys are like, oh, I want to defuse fights and I want to do this. I know I'm so scared. You got to stand for some shit sometimes,
ladies
Tommy.
This was a bouncer.
This man literally went to war. I don't know what the fuck you want.
Yeah.
He's from the Grange.
You. Yeah. To be fair, that's a more dangerous war zone than Iraq.
Dangerous.
All fair. All
pretty
considered.
Dangerous place.
But you were getting paid. You were getting paid. That's just unfortunate.
Life.
That's God not liking you too much.
So, just to show this to TJ real quick, as a reason he may want to come.
That's cool.
They buy all the weights from UT.
All the old UT weights. Yeah.
Damn. What time are you guys going?
Whatever. I got to get a gym day, and that was my thing. I've been working out. I'm a little lax today. I still have time to get my workout in today. I need to go to the gym and lift. That's one of the goals I have for
so
this
So these
month.
Are the murals over there on the turf yard.
Just tell me how that is.
Promised Michaela that I would go go on a hike, but I'm pretty sure I could sneak in a gym day too. I won't say no to that.
Yeah. I mean, but like, I was cool with them until they put that shit up. Now I'm going to go and disrespect their home.
Dude, they have a Lakers flag. That
I don't
has
care.
To balance it out.
Yeah, nah.
Bro, and look,
Lakers
you're in
are better than In-N-Out.
You're in Tejas.
Yeah, but that's just bandwagoning at that point. If you get rid of In-N-Out but have Lakers, you're a bandwagon. I hate
no.
you.
That burger's it's not good.
You're not good.
Like, it's just a fact.
You're brainwashed and you don't know any better.
Hey, on a good day, I'm gonna even be fair. On a good day, In-N-Out is like a 7 to 8 only in California.
7 to 8.
But the fries.
The fries are trash. I'll admit that. It's
but
not a fry
so,
place.
So if drinks don't really count, right? So let's say.
Excuse me, that pink lemonade is delectable.
It's
you like
lemonade.
Sweet shit. It's the sweetest shit of all time.
I like lemonade. I mean, hey, calm down. Don't throw my shit
I know.
If we're using if lemonade is your winning point, then you've already lost.
No, it's not the winning point. The burgers are the winning point. The freshness. The fact
no,
that your
not.
Shitty state
they
has no produce,
not.
No delicious
we
cows.
Produce,
we've talked about that.
No, we produce just as much.
We know.
And
you don't.
All the resources.
No.
All the resources for that because you live in a fucking desert that doesn't even see rain.
You don't have water.
We make 70% of the nation's produce. What the fuck are you
not
talking about?
anymore.
Not anymore.
After the wildfires, you don't.
We still do.
No.
Yes. No.
Only 5% of the Californian economy that you brag about comes from produce.
Yeah, the rest of it is fucking porno and Hollywood. No, it's, and the naval bases and
Silicon Valley.
I was getting there. Those are the things. that's that new money. Porn's always gonna. Porn and Hollywood always gonna be there, baby.
That's great. That's a thing to be proud of.
Right, you guys could be the energy capital of the fucking world with all the nothing in West Texas, just putting solar panels out there. But you refuse.
It's not us.
It's hubris. No, your fucking state doesn't want to do anything
smart.
Do you
want to murder birds?
Yeah, fuck them.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck about a bird.
Actually, I'm kind of with them on this one.
Yeah
West birds. Texas birds?
Yeah, West Texas needs something, man. Right.
It's all migratory birds. It's a fucking killing field.
It's scary out there, Marco. It's terrifying. But it's into a cult at any given time.
Right.
With all the things that Obama did, that it is getting greener and solar power are getting the bigger ups, and it's just cheaper. That's what it's getting cheaper.
No, yeah, about fucking birds. You guys are ruining everything with fracking. Come on, guys, we're guilty of it too.
We're not fracking right now because the price of oil is so cheap. Right.
Fair enough, but not like that's going to last forever. You know, going back to normal.
I had an entire.
I love how this podcast went from In-N-Out. I'm sorry, In-N-Out supremacy to. Infrastructure in the states that we're living in.
I did a structured case out on hydraulic fracking back in high school.
The fuck did you call me?
Hydraulic fracking.
So
kidding. I'm kidding.
Water being used for fracking.
Yes, hydro.
Dude, I kind of like this shirt.
I had to fight the pro side. It was hilarious.
Yeah.
So I was a monster. I was.
Yeah, I know you are.
Because
you like money. It's like this one debate I had with
the person.
It was
a debate in high school. I was getting paid, getting repertoire, which is...
There was a debate. Apparently, have you guys heard of... This is like completely random, but it's a good example of our morality in human and mass production. You guys know shoehorn crabs? Horseshoe crabs. If you've seen them, know about them.
Yeah, they have blue blood.
They got sweet nutrients. It's used in the medical field. People have these farms where they bleed them out, mm-hmm. up to maybe 20% of their lifeblood left. They send them out, and most of them die.
Right.
Okay. It's bad for them, but the nutrients in the blood allows for a lot of medical progression. We can make it synthetically, but it costs more. But taking it from their bodies and releasing them, even though it's probably going to kill them, costs less. What's the moral correct thing to do?
Fuck them crabs.
What he said.
Why?
Because fuck them crabs.
I feel like our lives mean more than the crabs' lives.
Why?
Because I can talk to TJ. I can't talk to a crab.
Dolphins can't talk.
Yeah, but they're cute.
They're also serial rapists.
They are. But if you... If you talk to one, maybe you could change them. I don't know. Befriend a dolphin and make them not a racist.
It's not that.
That's not
even
a good deed.
I'm just saying.
Here's my other aspect. If you want to really get economical about it, right? Yes, we can make it synthetically, but that would also require us to move funds into that sort of initiative, which in turn is already going to take it away from shit that probably needs it already.
Right, but are we really even giving the funds to the things that need it to the things that need it already?
So then why the fuck would we give it to blue crabs?
Because they have the sweet, sweet nutrients that give us good foods and materials for pharmaceuticals.
Can we eat the crab, or
they're not delicious.
Oh, so
if they were delicious, that would be awesome. But no.
I mean, can we mass produce these?
About farming crabs.
They're a lot. Yeah. There already is a lot, but they can not a surplus, but there's going to be a point where there's going to be no mo if they keep doing it this way.
Well, if they're farming them, then we're good.
Well, it's a good thing.
No, but they're not farming them. They're wild.
It's a good thing that people aren't fucking then, because that's actually going to solve almost all the problems from energy to the
people aren't wetting them.
Population in the U.S.
Yeah, the birth rate is super duper low.
Oh, yeah. Oh, people aren't fucking. Then I thought you said them, the crabs.
Is that like a consensus from like a year trend or what? Because last year
we're generally in the replacement level. Right
see,
now.
See, I'm pretty sure that most people
of men here after a while.
Yeah, yeah. I was like, I'm pretty sure most people were like, I ain't trying to have a kid during quarantine. That's what I said.
Yeah, coin toss. Yeah, kind of. Some people.
Not that I was
them.
Trying to have a child, but I was like, ain't no way I'm gonna have a kid.
Yeah, I didn't see that many accidental.
I saw a fair share.
Did you? Okay.
Mm-hmm. My sister being one of them. Not an accident, but had a kid. Same. Had a kid in. No, he wasn't born in quarantine, but she had one conceived during quarantine. But that was intentional, to be fair. Okay. But Yeah, I had a couple friends that they've conceived, and they're either already had them or going to be there. Like what has?
No, I'm pulling up the graphs of the birth rate, and then it's just like, shoo.
Yeah, because everything's expensive. God damn it.
The world sucks. Let's just be honest.
That's another one.
A lot of people don't want to bring another
life into this. No, the U.S. sucks.
Yeah, but we're in the U.S.
What the fuck are we, TJ? We can't afford to move abroad like you can, TJ.
Yeah, we don't have compounds in Zimbabwe. We can grow our families.
Yeah, go to fucking Eastern Europe.
He doesn't have kids either. I don't know why you're attacking
him. No, I'm saying he could have. He has the option at any moment. If he says, I want kids, he can fucking support them. If I wanted kids, if I found the woman I love and wanted to start my family tonight, I couldn't support them.
No, you'd be a
but you, meat. Yeah, I know.
He
but would, you, if you decide,
he could get
if you,
a nanny.
He could get a nanny.
He could get a fucking
nanny. You could have that and be all right. You'd be like, man, this kid's fucking expensive, but, because I know you, that's exactly what you'd say. Exactly but you'd love him just the same, but you'd whisper
you'd
in hushed tones.
Money. Somewhat okay.
Yeah, yeah, and you'd buy another property so you can spend more money so you can have daycare money.
Boom.
Yeah,
it's really bad.
Right.
Yeah. Wait, what was it? 1950? Man, they were fucking a lot in 1950.
Well, they were having a lot of kids.
Yeah. Yeah. Man, I guess.
Well, everything before like 1970 is like before real birth control.
1984.
Everyone's like, fuck that shit.
No.
yeah. Right.
So there's a chapter in Super Freakonomics where they talk about how abortion being legal in 1973 led to the birth rate in the 80s crashing.
No, but 84, it looks like it crashed even harder. Go back.
No, but that's what it means. It being legal so that the people that would have been having kids.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough.
Which means from that like rationale, it's a lot of people that probably shouldn't have been born.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. I mean, between. Some of those, yeah, no. People,
a lot of those abortions were from bad things.
Bad things, or just people that are stupid and didn't act right, or whatever, right?
This is not.
And I'm talking about men
against
mostly.
Abortions. At all, I'm gonna preface that, but it's actually really interesting when you say that, right? Because you know you have some. You, I mean, there's scenarios where you know people have a kid they really didn't want, and then like surprise, like end up having more, or, like end up enjoying.
And
that
it was
experience.
Back in the day, and there was some weird shit happening, right? Like uncles and just
Oh yeah. No.
Crazy.
The option. Women should have that right always, and they should have always had that right. Mm-hmm. Obviously,
no man should, my thing is no man should have. Any say in that.
Yeah, it's not your
no,
fucking
No, I follow the Dave Chappelle rule. No, let me pause. I do think that in terms of a conversation, if you're married, like mm-hmm. two-way street, you should have a fluid conversation. But at the end of the day,
she's involved in the situation.
Right.
Like, yeah, like I feel like, hey, like because Dave Chappelle pointed out, right, like, let's say you're on the opposite end, right, and the woman would like to have the kid. Mm-hmm. That is a legal tie for you, even if you don't want no part
right.
of that,
right?
And so that's where I'm like, yeah, we shouldn't have a say unless there. But there's always nuances and like conversations.
Yeah,
but at the end of the day,
your life is entwined.
But the option needs to be there always, and it needs to be accessible freely 100%. And openly.
Like
that's
like any woman at the end of the day, it is ultimately their decision. But right. I still support Dave Chappelle's notion of like, but if I don't want to pay for the motherfucker, I should not have to.
I don't have that belief, which is why I'm safe, and I practice safe sex.
Of course.
I mean, no sex is the safest sex.
Which is why I'm great. I am locked in, baby.
Set up.
Yeah, keep laughing. Keep laughing, Tommy, the way you're hoeing about with this girl. I love this girl. She got me hypnotized. You're going to leave it in, and she's going to have a little McGrew.
Wow.
Yo, you a hoe, bro.
Little McGrew.
You a real hoe.
I say no names, and it could be one of several people.
Bro,
that's
up for failure across the board.
Yeah, there's the blonde one, the redhead, the other redhead, the blonde one again, the brunette.
Bro,
now see, it's called smokescreen.
Yeah.
How much of this is real? No one knows.
That's not how this works.
No. Yeah, it is.
You're a
hey, bro,
human being.
It's fine. it's fine. Keep making fun of me not being sexually active right now.
Who was it? That was Marco.
Oh, no. Fine. Staring at me and laughing and pointing. That's.
Say anything. I mean,
here's how you make that exact same joke without even throwing him under the bus. You just be like, oh, hey, Tommy, especially because you're single, you should probably be careful out there.
No. Tommy needs to be under the bus sometimes, all right? He needs to see to make sure everything's working there.
That's like another thing that we need to teach Sam over thing, like because he's like all about gravitas and being a
hell
great,
yeah.
like
orator.
Story, orator, yeah. It's he always goes for the throat.
Bro, you go for the jugular.
Yeah.
Bro.
Yeah, and yet y'all still try to fuck with me.
Stop it.
No, just because you go for the jugular don't mean shit. That actually pisses me off.
All right,
have
then.
You met my fucking family?
Then guess what? Looks like it's going to be Clash of the Titans forever then, guys.
That's fine. That's why we're
all right. Playing. Tokyo's going to be torn down weekly.
Bro, you can make, like, there's times where a jugular shot, worth it. Worth it.
Right.
But, dog, hey, bro, hey, talking about crabs, nigga, if someone's punching you, bro, you... Listen, no, take this down TJ, with you. They ain't got to be like TJ, that.
My uncle literally pulled me aside and said, you ugly motherfucker.
And I've never done that.
You're one of the ugliest people I've ever seen.
Not done that.
That was my family. Anything he says does nothing. Does zero.
You're right.
And every time I see him, I'm laughing at you.
Yes,
yeah, you are. It's hilarious.
Yes, that shit's wrong.
I'm used to it, man.
I'm laughing at the scenario.
You're also laughing at the words, because I am.
But it could be anything. It's like, oh, man.
Family. You don't have to.
Oh, yeah. You could walk up to
Sam one day and be like, oh, man, the Raiders didn't look that good yesterday. It's like, Jerry Jones is a pedophile. And it's like.
That's what he would say to you.
Yeah.
To me, he'd be like Deshaun Watson, something about Deshaun
Watson. Yeah, because it's easy. It's
Why are we getting at the Houston Texans for supporting therapists? And massage therapist, excuse me.
I thought you meant like actual mental health therapist. No. You were like massage. Oh, ew.
Yeah.
They're not supporting.
Yeah, I don't think. They may be supporting his balls in their hand illegally, perhaps, but
no.
I don't know what they. I still haven't read it because I don't want to know.
No, see, look, but
it's weird. It gets very.
But
weird.
But what I'm saying is, it's not gonna go away. I'm sorry, and I'm gonna if I get into a fight, it's worked out pretty well so far.
Why doesn't your personality match your voice?
Wait, what's my voice?
Very calm.
Because
you know,
I trained it to be. Because you can't come out the gate.
I want to meet that person. The voice. That's the person I want him to be. You know, that'd be nice.
Honestly, if I'm gonna put you out there, if I'm gonna fuck you up, if I'm gonna mess with you guys, I'm gonna mess with myself. I've told Margos this plenty of times. When I have a girlfriend, I'm dope as shit. That calm Sammy is a cool motherfucker.
I've never seen
it. It's a unicorn. You guys barely have seen him. TJ didn't get to see him because he heard all the bad shit. He was my confidant during that era. And so, hey, there's more in there, baby.
I know.
If you go get me one, or I'll get you one. You want another one? All right. But point is, yeah, that guy, the voice, when I have a girl, I'm William D. Williams, man. I'm William D. Williams, baby. I'm cool as a motherfucker. I'll let him laugh at that and explain that joke. I'm
gonna if there was a god, this would totally play out. Sam gets a black eye from a roundhouse kick at TJ's party.
Yeah,
and then 2 weeks later, he meets a girl. It's like, oh, what happened? And then it's like he's already.
I will not
down.
Have fighting niggas at my.
That is what you call a meet cute, and I don't think Sam's gonna.
There's probably gonna be less people than you think. I keep it pretty because I got a sponsor shit, and it's still COVID. So there's gonna be like maybe select 20.
That's a lot of people.
That's a lot of people that can.
I
meet up Sam.
Are you guys plotting my jumping?
No.
Okay, just making sure.
He was explaining the situation.
All my homies are dope.
Until they meet him.
They've met him.
Yeah,
but it's cool at parties.
Fight with?
None, because they're his friends. They come. No, if they're with people, I know I'm a representative of them at that point.
So then you'll chill out.
Yeah.
Why can't you just do that?
Because fuck strangers, man.
They're strangers. You don't know them.
Yeah, but they know him.
Who gives a fuck?
If I act a dumbass and they go TJ, that's a reflection on TJ, not of me, because they'll never see me again. I assume.
Act different at Derek's party. He was very chill.
Yeah, dude, I was fighting with the Trump, not Trump supporter, but an Abbott supporter, and I didn't lose my cool. One of his homies.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Yeah, and so and I didn't lose my cool.
They literally work at the Capitol.
Yeah, and so time and place, man. But out in the wilderness, like out on 6th,
you let the leash off. That's the wrong place. I feel to let the leash.
That's the only place to let the leash off, man.
That's how people get shot. That's why it is what it is.
The math is there, man. Fuck
I don't
it.
Like road rage, right?
I don't road rage. I don't do that.
Do you not road rage, but you have 3 easy steps to get.
How do I not road rage?
Because he didn't drive from as early as we did.
One, well, yeah, I was like 22 and I learned how to drive.
That's weird.
Secondly, my dad has this mantra he told me and it just stuck in my head. Everyone's just trying to get home.
that to me stayed real important in my brain. So I don't fuck. Say. I don't fuck with people if people are cutting me off. I've only done it once.
I wish I'd heard that sooner.
Yeah. And so if people are speeding, acting stupid, making stupid turns, you could yell at them. But it's all surface level. Road, man, you fucking idiot! And then that's it. You don't get out your car and yell at them. What the fuck is that?
Or chase someone down.
Or chase someone down. Or honk. Or lean on your horn. I barely use my horn.
I didn't even
cut you off and just crazy.
I actually never knew that it because I mean it does not help that we are all from small country Texas towns where I definitely drove without a license.
Fair enough.
For like a while. And then I was like,
statute of limitations, leave it alone.
I mean, no one cares in a small town.
Nobody cares. I know the sheriffs.
Exactly.
Yeah, I know the police officers, so I'm good. Yeah.
Are you guys narcs?
I just know I'm safe. I know I'm like safe in that city.
School with the police chief of LaGrange.
Fair enough.
Both.
But you were saying in the small towns, you didn't know.
Oh, no. I just really didn't know that you. It took you so long to start driving.
So I didn't drive in high school because I was lame, as I mentioned before. And then UC Santa Barbara has a great public transportation system. And everything's walking distance or biking distance. So I know how to ride a bike.
On the beach, who the fuck would want to leave there?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So it's like, oh, I got to go to work. Bus. Almost damn near to work. Oh, I got to get to class. Bike 15 minutes maximum. I didn't even have a bike most of the time. I just walk. When you have all the time in the world, you don't really need a car. And then I had enough friends to give me rides to important places. Yeah, it was hard sometimes. Grocery shopping and shit on the bus. That was kind of whack, but just make do. It's beach living, man. Just make do.
I just think that...
that's bad drumming. But yeah, I have an announcement to make.
Oh. What's up?
So, all our birthdays are actually...
This sounded really scary, by the way. I was like...
Yeah, it was. He got our
attention. Are we getting a divorce? Is mom and dad, are you leaving?
Are you pregnant?
Yeah, it was really scary because he did an awkward drum. He's like, I got news.
Got an announcement.
It's a good announcement.
There you go, the levity in your voice. hold court above me in my nonsense.
No, I'm trying to be louder than your voice, so it's yeah. Good luck.
There you go.
But that being said, all our birthdays are pretty much next month.
When's your birthday?
October. Me and JJ's are right by
not his, but all of ours.
Yeah, that's three.
Yeah.
Which is why, you know, when you come, when we're in the birthday festivities, please, like, y'all guys are just as much birthdays.
Yeah.
Of course, July, baby. Come on. Next.
Yeah.
But, so,
honestly, not Capricorns. Cancers?
Cancers, well, Leo, emerging, or whatever the fuck that means.
Sure.
We cry a lot.
I don't know how to check the rising. What rising?
Ask Michaela next time y'all see her. She's
almost got me down that rabbit hole. Anyway.
Okay. Yeah.
But that being said, last year, Sam and JJ's birthday were pretty close to each other. So Sam, when he was still in his depressed state, decided, hey, I want to do an all-day streaming event. It'll be me starting to get my foot through the door to come back.
Right.
So him and JJ, we did the manpower to kind of work things out. Sam does more than what we do. But this time, I'm trying to kick it up a notch.
Yeah.
Our back chat talked about having a King of the Controller tournament.
Oh, that's the name we settled on. I like that.
Yes.
We outsourced it.
Did we?
He did. I'm not even going to take credit for that, baby.
When you talk about HR doing emails and talking to people, I talked to a marketing person. Oh. I've been talking to two different venues.
I still think TJ's Ego Boost is the best tournament name we
could
have.
So TJ thinks I've been crying, he's the god of the champions.
And I've been crying about the logistics.
There's like, okay, so I looked at the sections, and I just know that there's one where I have a really good shot at dominating.
And I think we need more games.
What do you mean?
That's already
a lot of games.
Yeah, there's already 18 games.
I want more. I think.
Or maybe diversification.
There's already a chance that we can make it through this whole tournament and not all the games will be played.
Yeah. Right, but the style of games are all very similar. I want
a
little diversity.
They're all literally different categories.
There's three in each.
I know, but I don't have an Xbox, and like all half the games are Xbox, so fuck that. I don't want to lose that way.
We all have X. I have like two.
Which you have.
I bought an X.
Yeah, I don't have one. I've never had a 360. Xbox.
There's people that, bro. But if you need, I can buy. It's whatever.
You can buy me one.
No, not you.
He'll buy one. You can borrow it for a little bit.
So only the shooting games are Xbox.
Yeah, and I will get eliminated. At least Apex is.
Well, you're gonna get eliminated
cross
anyway.
Platform.
They all have the same thing.
Same
you
physics,
shoot with the
same
trigger.
Buttons,
they're different.
No, they're not at all.
Well, Gears of War is very fucking
Jared,
different.
Gears of War
well,
is
that's specifically for
and it's going to be like, press Y, and I'm going to think it's R2.
My only contention would be in the racing games category, I would actually want one normal racing game.
Wait. Mario Kart's normal?
No.
Oh, you're talking about like a Gran Turismo type?
Yeah,
Wreckfest is Burnout type.
Oh, no,
it's like a... mixture of Burnout and your traditional Gran Turismo.
See, type. I would want a straight up like racing type game for
it's
those who
a
prefer
lot of
that.
Fun.
We might get rid of F-Zero then, maybe.
My thing was like it felt to me like every other category has like one that's a little like or one that's normal, one that's a little like really wonky, one that's
this is really interesting when they don't know what the fuck we're talking about in terms of games. Just
well, we already said it's a King of the Controller.
Right.
Let me go over it real quick. The how the tournament going to work, and then we'll talk about the games for a little bit and end the show. So the way the tournament works is, so we're hoping to fill a bracket of 16 and very optimistic that maybe we can fill a bracket of 32. How it works is you spin a wheel. On that wheel there's a different video game. Wherever the wheel lands, that's the video game that you play. One round, if there's any kind of dispute, like Smash, about like, no, I want all the items, I want no items, key is the
see no I
party
think, no I think we need to establish that before, because he's not gonna be there and we're not gonna look at the chat and we're not gonna have a good signal, so
we could talk about that later.
Yeah, but no, fuck that, all items, random stages.
No,
see, this is why this will be a debate and we need a third party outsource.
Yeah,
right, but we gotta establish that before.
And also arbitration.
And also TJ, I'm gonna just say this because it's also fun part of the show, you're boring for playing Smash Brothers Fox only, Final Destination no items. You're boring.
I do not play with Fox.
You're
I don't
whatever
play Final Destination only.
Well, fine, what's the other one that's flat now?
I mean, technically, any map can be Final Destinationized, but
no,
it's Omega variations.
Whatever. The point is, you're boring, and you make me sad. It's like being like, oh, man, here's sex. You could have as many positions, whatever, and you choose missionary, no items.
So, and then for everything outside.
I'm gonna shove this goddamn thing up his ass. Like, straight up.
Hey, no items. That's your rule, fucker.
Jesus. Yeah, we need someone to oversee this.
It may not be key. I'm aiming for it to be key.
He's 12. He doesn't know anything.
He knows more about video games.
He knows
than
a lot about
I know video. A lot about video games. What are you talking
I don't
about?
Know much about much.
You can't arbitrate for yourself.
He would try.
That's true. That's the only thing. Don't say I don't know video games. Just say I can't arbitrate for myself.
I wouldn't say you don't know video games, but like to be like a video game head is like a lot of work.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I have a life. I need to live life.
Like,
a
because
bit.
I mean, like, I like. Can you tell us what was the biggest names within E3? Like stuff like that.
Within E3?
Yeah, with
did
last
you watch
E3.
It?
I got
did you
the
watch
highlights because it's all the same shit.
Yeah, no, it's not. Halo, I watch E3.
Halo Triple Ultimate, and then you got like probably like Madden 22 is coming out, and then you got like
literally. Every kid's game on this list was from Sam.
Got Super Monkey Ball 2 coming now.
Maybe we need to reconfigure and get some voters preference on some of the options.
Man, I'm switching one of mine to RC Racing on classic Nintendo.
No,
where are you going to find these games?
Very easily. We're sponsored in effect by Blue Shell Gaming out of Fresno, California. Three locations now in the Central Valley.
They have every game ever created.
Damn near. They have a lot of product.
But I was just saying that in terms of most of the categories,
F-Zero GX,
there's like
a
good
game.
Like mix of like, hey, like, cause okay, I'll take shooting for example. I believe it's Halo 3, Call of Duty, and then it's Gears of War, right?
Yes.
Gears of War, wonky. It's like it's the most different one. Then you have Halo, where there's a lot of familiarity. A lot of people played Halo.
Simple enough.
But
I couldn't
it's
afford.
Also not, it's also not the textbook, right? Yeah. Then you have Call of Duty, which is the textbook.
Right.
And I wasn't like, allowed to play shooting games growing up because we don't want to murder
fuck
cops.
Is that our problem?
Oh, and I'm just saying you're degenerates. I just want you to feel bad about it.
We don't.
Why?
Well, because that's the sole reason why you went to the military is Call of Duty.
That's not
you like murdering. You like murdering Russians in an airport and some other war crime. I don't know.
What?
Sam, you love Street Fighter and you never took up karate.
Never.
Because I can't beat up a fireball Brazilian who shoots electricity.
There's no fireball Brazilian in Street
Fighter. I know. Let me rephrase the sentence.
There's a lightning Brazilian.
I can't fireball a lightning Brazilian.
She's new.
But you can shoot an Arab dude. That's in those games, and you can do it in real life if you sign up for the U.S. military.
Whoa, but Arab dudes can also shoot back. That's what the best part about these games. Play multiplayer, baby.
Very true.
But okay, so that was the but using that as an example, right? The shooting game section to me was the most where I was like, that is like a healthy mix of a lot of games that are very familiar, but also, you know, people can flex on. What I was going to propose is, instead of having the, I would move some of the things that are in the miscellaneous into fighting, move, and then have a third section.
Well, miscellaneous was just like, these are games that we really want, but they just don't fit. So Sam wanted Super Street Fighter 2. I don't even know what system that's for.
64, you can get anything.
Dragon Ball Fighters. That was what Tommy really wanted.
That's what most people would want, baby.
Yeah, that's what that's why I picked it. It would be him especially. But yeah.
I will literally.
But that's literally like a death roll. If
you're not, you're not strategic, Tommy. You got to be strategic. If you have a pick, don't pick
MK11
a game.
MK11 was my strategic.
Yeah, but there's people better than you in this room at MK11. Not me. More comments for suckers. But
the last section I was going to propose was because I saw Nidhogg and I was like, that's a really good idea. So instead of going about and having the miscellaneous category, fuck Sammy's options. And then have an indie section where it's like those smaller indie-er games.
Like Crawl.
Yeah, like Crawl. Like those little competitive games that are more indie. They're not really, because Nidhogg's not really a fighting game. It's not, it's more competitive, but it's indie, right?
Like Pong.
Yeah. So like that.
We would need to redo the list, but we got time. And we also got I am staying here this weekend to get the trophies for the tournament to
make them good.
Yes. Yeah. I'm staying here this weekend to make sure whatever games that we don't have, like whatever we don't have a physical copy of, I'm going to go to GameStop and try to get them.
I'm pretty sure that like a majority of the Xbox games, as long as we have Game Pass, we're good.
Edward's bringing his Xbox, and so that's perfect. Where
I hope this thing becomes a tradition, and it's a yearly thing that you know whoever won it can flex.
Where's it gonna be at?
Well, we're working on the venue. That's why I said I'm in communication with two places. I don't want to say preemptively where it's gonna be.
But not at my house. Fuck that. I ain't have no 16 people in here. I barely like you guys here.
I would say that it'd be really dope. If you need help on any of those communications, I would say like, hey, because then that opens up the door for some prizes.
Oh,
yeah! I already done that. Real quick, bit. Sorry. I like it. Hold that thought. Yes.
So this trophy, I would like to keep it amongst ourselves. What if an outsider wins?
Well, then they better come back.
It is an open tournament. I don't want to limit
have to buy a trophy every year.
Or.
If TJ wins, like he thinks he's going to win, then we keep the trophy.
If I could just roll in the same category, I'll be fine. If I'm in the fighting game category and good one's not there, I should be okay.
I'm inviting him. I don't know if he's going to accept.
But like I said, I'm assuming he's a busy man.
He's probably very busy. So is he. We're all busy. All adult males with jobs.
Time out. Hey, can I just say, if you mention one more goddamn time that you got work, dog, we all got work. You be saying that a lot.
Like a motherfucker.
What are you talking about?
Bro, you be like, hey, lad, I got work tomorrow. Nigga, we all got work.
Yeah, but I got to wake up early.
Motherfucker, I wake up at 5.
I wake up at 6.
That's your guys' fault.
Fucking California.
You've seen me work overnight.
But anyways, what I was going to say.
You guys fall into that trap very easily.
Every single time.
It's California, so easy. Hey guys, I'm dropping a net. And you guys sprint towards the pit.
Go.
Texans, what are we doing with this trophy nonsense?
He's getting an old karate trophy.
Shut up.
No, the trophy should be revealed on the day of, but yes.
No trophy. No trophy, guys. I'm sorry. I feel bad now.
You rolled your R at me. So that's really weird.
Got your attention. Here's the deal. We need a championship belt.
Those are way more expensive than trophies.
Yeah, let's
we'll all pitch in and TJ will pitch in a lot.
No, don't sign me up. I was going to chip into this like $25 gift card to Chili's we're about to get out.
Triple dipper will be one of the prizes.
It'll be a prize.
In third place, you get a triple dipper.
I was about to say, but that's only if it stayed amongst us. If it was like our competitive trophy for whenever we did something competitive with each other, that
all right.
Would be we can have an internal trophy. Sorry
to thought,
I ain't giving that to
I already thought $50 gift card to Mexlin's gift shop, $20 Chili's gift card.
It covers.
That's enough for a triple dip.
And an app. And an app, I think.
Or a drink. Or a beer. Drink.
Your choice. You're right.
Okay. Yeah. What other prizes that are Mexlin?
I was straight going to do an Amazon gift card.
Yeah, I was going to. I can do $100 Amazon.
We don't want to support them, even though I bought a bunch of things from Amazon.
It's hard not to, yeah, right?
But no. See, I'd rather just give them cold hard cash.
Do that then.
Let's do that.
$100 bill.
$100 bill. Crisp.
Can we get a big check?
We can. Dude. All it takes is some poster board and some paper that you print out some stuff out there.
But I would say.
Can you make me one of the fat checks?
If anyone's hearing this or this gets shared amongst the people, please give a huge, huge, really big shout out to Marco for all the hard work he's been putting in. A lot of the back end stuff for this is like all in him.
A whole lot.
And been super supportive of it because it's dope. Sounds dope. But I am the back end analytics guy, so I've not done anything for this yet. And I haven't even done any sort of promotional sort of planning for
it. Right.
But I'll figure it out once we solidify everything.
Man, I'm jealous, man. You put in a little work and they applaud you and they sing your praises, man. That must be real nice.
Hey, you ain't that must be open that real kind of worms nice. Right now. Don't do that.
That
don't do that.
That fucking, well, Sam, if someone does want to praise you, how can they find you?
You can find me on 6th Street and push me, and then I'll say, hey man, you don't want none of this shit. And then you can know me intimately in a fist fight. So you know more about a man when you fight him. So eventually I will know all these guys by the end of the night very well. You can find me at The Maxlence on all forms of social media. I'd like to tell you that we could get it adjusted, but alas, it's very difficult. No, I'm not naming any names. But The Maxlence for right now on all forms of social media. Tommy, where can they find you?
Call the trophy Danielle.
What?
It's a league reference because they named their trophy Shiva after the crush. So yeah, I mean, trophy has to have a name. So there you go.
Tommy, where can they find
where can they find
Tommy McGrew _ art Instagram.
Holla at your boy TJ. TJ Manna on Instagram. Don't look me up on Facebook. Don't message me up on Facebook. You won't get a reply.
And I don't even get a reply, and I'm one of his best friends.
Are you though?
And if you want to find me, just type JOMarco62 into anything, and I will pop up. That being said, if you want to sign up for the tournament, please hit up any of us on social media so that we can get the bracket formulated as fast as we can. We'll probably be taking competitors to an hour before.
I also want to encourage, even if we fill up slots, still come through, hang out. I'm certain that we'll have some downtime afterwards and beforehand, and there'll be games there. I still don't even know how we're going to implement a lot of these things, but
don't worry, TJ. That's my job.
We already did a practice session here. It's the same game plan. But
and be vaccinated, you fucks. I don't want to talk to you if you're not vaccinated. I don't want you fucking near me. So you have time. Go get fucking vaccinated. I don't want to fucking deal with you. Get vaccinated. Just saying. I want to tell people if they're not vaccinated that they can go fuck themselves and don't join our tournament. You guys can believe otherwise. I'm the one that said it, though. And we can fight about it.
Let's go get some chili triple dippers.
Yeah!